for one, am grateful, Mrs. Bush, that they are finally bringing civilization to this savage land.
I could not agree with you more, my dear. My daddy settled this land, and I know he'll be looking down on us, pleased at how we helped the natives.
Yes, they've lost their land, but they've gained access to heaven.
But Father, do you mean unless an innocent receives communion, they're destined to go to hell? That hardly seems fair.
What I mean to say, Jenny, is that there is a great deal of difference between an innocent and a savage.
I never thought of it that way.
Yes, they live like animals, but they're happier now.
Not only do people now have motor cars, Father, but I heard that pretty soon we will be able to fly.
No, only angels can fly, Jenny.
No, apparently people can fly. Didn't you hear? Out in Kansas, a man even got a car to fly.
I hardly think so, Jenny.
Apparently, Mr. Johns wants to run for governor, which is why he's so concerned with cleaning up the state.
Nate Johns.
Yes.
His family is nothing but hillbilly trash that came here after the war. I don't want to be judgmental, but this state should not be ruled by such a disgusting family. A family without class.
Apparently. The Johns family have made a lot of money, and he has a lot of friends in politics.
Mrs. Bush, money isn't everything. There are many things that money cannot buy.
It seems that money can buy voters, though.
What you must remember, my dear, is that we have been brought here to spread the word. And the word and civilization, they are the same thing. They are the gifts. It is the opportunity we have, the chance to live among people who are decent and who do not kill each other, and who let you worship in peace.
It's so confusing, Father. Sometimes I find it impossible to make the distinction between a loving act and a hateful one. I mean, they often seem to be the same thing.
Yes, Jenny, it is confusing. But you only have to ask me if you need help.
Indeed.
Well, here we are, Mrs. Bush. Armadillo.
John Marston.
Sometimes.
I'm Jake. Your friends from Blackwater hired me to guide you.
They ain't my friends, but pleased to meet you, Jake.
I got the horses saddled up and ready out front. So what are you doing up at the fort?
I'm looking for an old friend.
Well, like I says, you ain't gonna find many folk around those parts these days. Those you do find are about as sociable as an ulcerated back tooth. I mean, I ain't one to judge a man by the company he keeps, but...
Well, he ain't been friends for a long time.
Whoa there!
Listen, mister. This here is what's left of Fort Mercer. Some gang rode in and took the place over.
So I understand.
This is where we part ways, friend. You have yourself a good time.
B!
come for you! Bill Williamson! Come out here right now!
Go away now, John. Don't make me kill you.
Nobody needs to kill anyone, Bill.
You must think I was born yesterday. You always did think I was an idiot.
That ain't fair, Bill. You were as my brother. I've come to try to save you.
Oh. Do I look like I need saving?
Bill, please. They want to kill us all. I can help you.
Well, you never tried to save me before. You only seemed to save yourself.
Bill, I implore you think about this.
You implore me? You implore me. You always were one for fancy words. Oh. Well, things are different now, John. Now I'm in charge! No more Dutch! And no more you. Implores. I implores you to go back and tell them to send someone just a little bit more impressive next time.
Well?
Oh. Poor John.
That was close. Too close. We brought that trouble on ourselves.
By we, you mean me.
The one me who went and shot him.
Seemed like he deserved shoot.
I'm sure he did. But I've been thinking, ain't it about time you stopped being the man making them decisions?
I'm trying.
Are you?
I think so.
I gotta find someplace to lay low. Keep quiet.
Maybe Dutch was right. Maybe we should have just gone to Tahiti.
Is that it with you? Tahiti or killing? Come on, John. Please, try.
Try what?
We gotta live somewhere for more than just a few weeks.
Okay. Let's see what we can find in Strawberry. What do you know about Strawberry?
I know they like good, honest, hard-working men a whole lot more than angry killers. So make yourself good and honest.
I am always honest. Maybe not always good, but I'm always honest.
My whole life I've been surrounded by fools with moral codes. Here's the moral code. Look out for folks. Stop trying to act like some hero in a book.
What do you know about heroes and books?
My reading's getting pretty good.
Well, read different books then.
I've been reading about knights. You know, of the Round Table.
The king. What's his name?
There's King Arthur. And there's Sir Lancelot, and the Lady Guinevere, and a whole lot of others.
Those names.
I kinda like them.
You know what? So do I.
I bet that sign says Strawberry, don't it? I got a good feeling about this place. Been a long time. Why don't you pull up just here?
I'm gonna go see what kind of good, honest work I can find. Grave digging or polishing some rich fella's boots or some such.
Me too. See if me and the boy can find some laundry work or something.
Yeah, heard that.
Help you, son?
I'm hoping I can help you. I saw the help wanted sign outside.
Sure, but you're a bit old to be stacking groceries and running errands, ain't you, son?
Well, I ain't too proud to do nothing. As long as it's honest, and it pays.
Time's hard, Mr.
Milton. Jim Milton. Mm. Yeah, my wife and I, and our boy, we was robbed a few days ago. Lucky to get out with our lives, we was. Now, well, We need money.
There's bad folk out there.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Got a wagon by any chance?
Sure.
Well, then maybe you could run some goods up to Pronghorn Ranch for me. You know, head west past Owen-Gila, then follow the road north, leads right there.
I don't know where that is, but I'm sure I can find it. I can leave right now if you'd like.
It's Getty's place. Fine fella. Where's the wagon?
It's just outside. You know, I should go tell my wife, and then I can come back and get loaded.
Well, my boys can load you up while you go find your wife.
Okay.
Thank you, Doctor. Hey, how you getting on?
I found some work.
Me too.
Delivering goods out to some ranch.
Cleaning a doctor's surgery.
Fine living.
It is, John. Oh, it is. This is the way to it.
I'll take your word on that. Well, what do you suggest now?
I'll stay here. Get on with the work. You deliver them goods and then collect me.
Okay.
And John, I love you. Don't you forget that. Not ever now.
I won't. You Mr. Geddes?
No, sir. I'm Mr. Dickens, his overseer.
Jim Milton. I'm delivering some supplies from the store in Strawberry.
Okay.
This is quite a place.
Yes. It's beautiful. Oh.
They send everything?
Yeah, I think so.
So, partner, your boss, he looking for hands?
Why? You looking for work?
Yeah. My wife, we was in business with her family and turned sour. It's a long story.
Yeah, I don't know. Married hands, it's a lot of trouble.
I'm a good worker. My wife, Agatha, even our boy. Lancelot, we'll all work.
Big man around, boy? Get the hell out of here.
Now, that ain't very neighborly.
And threatening us is neighborly?
Hey, mind if I enjoy one of these apples?
Put that down.
Delicious.
Oh, when's boss man gonna sell this place, boy?
I don't think there's any plans for that.
You boys want a drink? It's some fine scotch whiskey.
Put that down! Put that down!
Oh, these supplies for the season.
Get off the farm!
Come on! We know when we're not wanted.
Get down from there!
Bye, bud!
Come back here!
Oh, shit!
Hey!
Thank you. Milton, isn't it? Those boys are out of Laramie, work for Mr. Abel. Thank you.
Don't mention it. Listen, I ain't looking for no charity or nothing, but I was serious. You got work? We'll work. I can do anything. We got robbed ourselves a few days back.
We ain't got married hands here. You're married.
Work harder than any one of them. I'm real honest, and my wife, even though she's got fancy thoughts, she'll work.
Seem kind of desperate. What trouble you in?
No trouble, sir. Aside from her brother. He tricked us and robbed her of her inheritance. We're good people. We'll work. Even Lancelot.
What does Mr. Geddes need with a boy? Just another mouth to feed.
Just please give us a chance. I can handle myself okay. You know that already.
Yeah. Makes me wonder just who would have robbed you. But we'll give you a chance. I'll let Mr. Geddes know when him and his wife return tomorrow.
Thank you, Mr. Dickens. I'll go get my wife.
No, you stay here. It's getting late. We'll go get her in Strawberry. We'll bring her here tomorrow. We need you around in case any more of them Laramie boys turns up. There's a little cabin out yonder past the ranch house. Things work out, y'all can stay there.
Thank you. You'll not regret this.
Yep. Go get yourself settled. We'll have work for you tomorrow when Mr. Geddes returns. Milton, get over here.
Mr. Geddes, this is the new ranch hand I told you about.
Well, I heard you had some trouble with your welcome, but you kept your nerve and protected my property.
Nah, it was nothing, sir.
Well, David Geddes, pleased to meet you.
John, Jim, Milton. Thank you for the opportunity, sir. You and Mr. Dickens.
Well, you work hard. You be honest, you'll get your keep. I promise you that.
Boy has a family.
Well, lucky man. Then you better work extra hard. Good day,
howdy, sir.
Gentlemen.
Sir.
You hear that, John, Jim? Extra hard. Hey, get over here.
Mr. Dickens?
Go find old Jim Milton here something to do. Make sure he works extra hard.
Sure, Mr. Dickens.
Say, is that your family getting in the wagon morning, up sir. There?
Ah, believe it is. Mind if we go welcome them?
Not at all. Hey, is it true what they said about you when you arrived? That you ran off those hired guns?
Look, can we, not discuss this in front of my wife?
Oh, no, sure. Yeah, of course, mister.
Mrs. Milton!
Jim Milton, how fine you seem. This kind man just collected us. Thank you, sir.
I think we can be okay here. It's ranching work. This place is kind of...
It's fine. But I hear you began your career in ranching by throwing your weight around. Real wise, Jim.
What was I supposed to do? The place was getting robbed.
So you show everyone who's boss? Real fine.
I didn't have much of a choice. I gotta go. Jack, when you're done in here, come on out and lend a hand.
Here's the cows. Yeah, we used to have a bunch of women here did most of the milking. Most of them drifted off.
Okay.
You fine with milking?
You know, I ain't really done much of it. Could never really get the hang of it.
You serious, mister?
Sure. It's Jim. Jim Milton.
Hey, sit down, I'll show you how. Approach her calm now. She don't take too kindly to surprises. You got the hang of it. Almost got a pail full.
Hey, Pa.
Is that your boy?
Sure. Hey, Lancelot.
Well, hey, Lancelot.
Hey.
We're gonna make a dairy maid of your paw yet.
I never thought I'd see the day.
Watch and learn, partner. We all gotta earn our keep.
That's enough, Jim. Come on. How about you and the boy help me clean out the stables?
Sure. Come on, son.
Hey.
Hey.
Where's Jack?
Shoveling shit in pursuit of the better life you want. Same as I've been.
Won't do him no harm.
I know.
Guess maybe we can last here. Survive. Do a little better than survive for once. I'm tired of fleeing, John. So, well, you know.
Me too.
I'll put some coffee on.
Hey, Milton. Can you give me a hand with this fence?
Sure.
Know much about fence building?
Not really.
Can't build a fence, can't milk a cow, ain't used to shoveling shits, but took on a gang of robbers single-handed.
Guess we all got our peculiarities, Mr. Dickens.
What was you doing before you came here?
I told you. Wife got cheated out of inheritance. We was in a legal dispute. It was a bad time.
That sounds awful, but I guess I don't believe a word of it.
I was raised to take a man at his word, and also to believe this is a free country. So free that I can't tell you what to think. So I guess it don't much matter what you believe. But I will work hard, and I learn fast.
Okay. Give me a hand with this fence. Yep, there's plenty more to do. I got other matters to attend to, but there's more than a day's work here for you.
All right. So long.
I'll be counting sections when you're done.
Okay.
I'm headed to work today myself, Jack.
Huh?
So you stay out of trouble.
Where are you working?
I told you. I'm cleaning at the doctor's office. Bye.
Bye.
Give the place a tidy.
Okay, Pa.
I'll see you later.
You want to watch your mouth, boy. You will be the first one we kill.
Leave him alone.
Oh, careful, boys. Careful.
Yeah.
Look at this tough guy.
Get out of here.
How fancy parents get is paying you to be tough for him, huh?
No, he's paying me to keep the place clean.
Oh.
Said he had some problems with vermin.
Oh, listen to this. Real funny.
Come on, get him.
Oh, kick his head in, boss.
Mr. Milton. It's like that, huh? I'm gonna smell like cow dung, boys. Oh, boy.
Get off that man! Get off!
He hit me first.
Oh, you can fight, boy. I'll give you that. Well, how's your wife in a brawl?
Leave my wife alone.
Oh, she's real pretty.
Get out of here.
Oh, quite a temper you got. Imagine you're frustrated with your lot in life, married to a shit-shoveling farmhand. What'd you do wrong to end up here?
Leave my wife alone.
Welcome to Big Valley, Jim Milton. Pleasure to meet you both. We'll see you again. And you, boy, tell Mr. Geddes we called. We'll be back.
Thank you, Mr. Milton. Thank you.
Don't worry about it.
Stop acting like a goddamn storybook hero, will ya?
What choice did I have?
Plenty, you moron. Plenty.
We all get caught eventually, John. I guess the trick is to decide by who.
I heard we had another incident with the Laramie boys.
Yeah, there was an incident.
Well, they mean to scare me.
Are you scared?
A little. I've got a lot invested in this place, and not just the land, but my family. It's hard to explain.
I understand. I'll do my best to keep you safe, sir. Yeah,
I know you will. So how's your family?
Just fine. I should probably head back.
Yeah, I know how it is.
How'd you get on?
Okay, I guess.
Better?
Sure, I'm just tired.
I know. Anybody want some more?
No, I'm thank good. You. I miss Mr. Pearson.
John Marston, you're such a pig! All right, it's getting late. Let's get some rest. Good night, Jack.
Good night, Mama.
Good night, Jack.
Good night, Pa.
What the hell was that?
What are you doing?
My job, Abigail. Lock this door behind me. Don't open it unless you know it's me.
Jim, you gotta do something. Two of them by the stalls. Get the cattle
out of here.
Who's this?
New hand.
They've killed Mr. Tolbert, and they've stolen my goddamn cattle. You men okay?
I think so.
Yeah. Jim Milton saved my life. It's Mr. Abel.
Yeah, of course, it's Mr. Abel. I can't believe he thinks it can scare me out of here.
Then I guess we're getting your cattle back,
I guess we are. Can you go too, Tom?
Of course, sir.
All right, Jim, I know you can handle yourself.
A little.
Go get your guns and head out.
Guns?
Oh, don't play coy with me, son. We need your help. I don't care what you used to do or what your name is. This is the land of second chances.
Understood.
Okay.
Come in, it's me.
What was it?
Mr. Getty's cattle was taken.
God, I'm sorry to hear that. What are you doing in that thing?
Mr. Getty's been real good to us.
What are you doing?
My job, Abigail. My goddamn job.
Off your horses here. We'll be better on foot.
Okay.
If you say so.
That's the place up ahead.
There's our cows. A couple guards out front. A couple more around the side, I imagine. Let's get a closer look. Let's go. Yeah, there's plenty of guards. I'm gonna head straight in.
Yep.
Tom? You head up there and try and give us some cover. Abe, you're gonna try and flank the place and come in from the back. I'll give you a minute or two, then I'm heading in.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Hey! Hey! You boys been coming up to Pronghorn. I thought I'd come down here. You're all so tough. Come have a word with me.
You here to cut a deal? You're too late, partner.
I'm here for our cattle and to teach some manners to all of you.
You seen how many men we got? As many as money can buy. Now get out of here, Hayseed, before you get a hole in your head. Just shoot him.
I tried being reasonable. Look out, Tom! Let me deal with this!
That woman of yours got the look of a woman ain't had a real ride in her life. She's gotta make do with some piss-poor stinking farmhand. Hey, hey!
You saved my
life. No need to say nothing, sir. Just doing my job. Now, I don't think they'll be back tonight, but how about Abe? Just in case, you stay up.
Yep.
You see anything or hear anything, you fire that rifle three times.
Three times.
We'll all come running.
Will do.
Well said. And thank you, Mr. Milton. Truly.
Just glad to be of service, sir.
I understand. You get some rest.
Thank you, Mr. Geddes. What? What? What choice did I have? Just answer me that. What was I supposed to do?
Just do one thing or another. Not be two people at once. That's all I'm saying.
How you getting on?
Surviving. I think.
Here. I'll get you some coffee.
Only thing I know how to do is... Well, no. Undertakers like me. Cattle? Not so much.
That ain't true.
I ain't no rancher. Rustled horses, not raised them. Stole cattle, not birthed them.
I was reading the newspaper. I was reading about a old ranch, Beecher's Hope, down by Blackwater.
Was you?
Well, Jack read it to me, but I thought maybe we could raise some money. Bank could lend us the rest. We could be happy, John.
Loans? I got a goddamn price on my head, woman.
I know all about that. Every time we about to get somewhere, make something, you go and show the entire world that you ain't Jimmy Milton. Every place we've been has been the same. We start doing okay and then boom, you act like the big man with the gun. Tired, John, and I guess I was dreaming a little. At least give me that.
Just feels hopeless.
You're doing better.
Milton! Milton, ma'am, Mr. Geddes needs you to head over to Strawberry in the wagon and collect some mail for him at the post office.
Sure. I'll take the boy with me. He's getting soft. Lancelot.
Come on. Jim, if you're heading that way, can you pick up a parcel for me? Address I ordered. I think it's in your name.
My name.
I think so. One's in your name and the other one's in mine. Only one should have come in by now.
How much shopping you done?
Oh, yes, a real keen purchaser of goods, me. Look at me.
Okay, Lancelot. We'll make a man out of you yet.
Not too much of a man, mind. He's only a boy.
Just gonna show him how to drive the wagon a little. We'll save the real exciting realities of adulthood for another day. You know, I think this is the longest I've seen you without a book in your hand.
It was foolish to forget mine, sir.
Look, I got some business to attend to with the clerk. I leave you with the wagon. Can I trust you not to drive off with it?
Oh, I think I can be trusted in that.
Very good. Hi, I'm here to...
Name?
My name? Jim Milton.
Jim Milton. Hmm. Nope, nothing here.
Maybe try Marston. John Marston. It's a long story.
Okay. John Marston. Marston... Nope. Nothing here for that name either.
Try Abigail Roberts.
Abigail Roberts. Abigail Roberts. Yes, here we are.
And also, I'm here to pick up the deliveries for Pronghorn Ranch. David Geddes sent me.
Pronghorn? Yes. Sign here. We have a bunch of stuff for you. And I will help you out.
I'll take these. You get the rest of the stuff.
Here. Let me help you with this, Mr. Marston.
It's mostly Milton these days. It's a long story.
Whatever you say, Mr. Milton. It's not important. Take care now. Give my regards to Geddes.
Thank you very much, mister. Okay, let's get out of here.
Everything okay, Pa?
Sure. I hope so, at least.
Here, you take the reins a little.
I ain't sure.
Come on, son. You'll enjoy it if you try a little harder.
Okay. Okay, Pa. Are we just gonna turn around and go back?
That's what we're doing. Turns out, I missed the seclusion of the ranch more than I figured for.
Don't you want to go to the store or the saloon or anywhere?
We're going back. Okay, boy?
But I've been sitting in this wagon I don't know how long.
But nothing. Keep on driving and watch the road.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Jesus. Mind your father, okay? I got my reasons, even if I don't care to explain them.
Yes, sir.
Better. Who's this?
Sorry, sir. Was that a question for me?
No. No, keep driving.
Well, I don't like driving across here.
It's the same as any other road. Look where you want to go and the horse will follow.
Okay. I think the horse is getting skittish.
You'll be all right. Huh?
What?
Nothing. Just keep driving. Okay.
What? What's wrong?
Don't look around.
Oh, Pa, hey. Those men, are they following us?
Just stay calm. See that fallen tree? When we get there, stop the wagon, jump down, and hide.
Oh, Pa.
You need to do exactly as I say, boy. Here, now! Come on, quick, down! Okay, son, you wait here. You don't move or say nothing until I speak to you. You hear?
Yes, sir.
Head down. Okay, gentlemen, let's see what you come calling about. What do you boys want with us?
Oh, we just want to have a friendly chat. Are you John Marston? You sure look like him.
Truth is, I killed John Marston. And I'm happy to kill you, too.
You're talking bullshit, mister.
It's okay. You're okay.
What? Why? What?
It's okay. It's okay. Come on. Keep them eyes closed. Let's go. Come on. Giddy up. If you hadn't listened, things could have gone real wrong for us. There. We're okay. Hey, you know, your mama wants us to buy some old ranch. You read to her about it, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
What was it called?
Mm-hmm.
What was the name, boy?
Peacher's Home.
That's right. Peacher's Home. Over by Blackwater. You like the idea of that, huh? Us owning a ranch?
I don't know.
I can see you as a rancher's boy. Like Duncan Geddes, huh? I wasn't so sure, but yeah, that kind of life might suit us. It wouldn't be such a chore if the horses we were cleaning up after was ours, would it? No, it wouldn't. Go say hi to your mother.
How was the... What happened?
Yeah, we got shot at.
Shot at? What happened?
Well, we got followed, and then we...
Followed by who?
Probably someone who knew me. If we didn't get to them particulars, I'm sorry.
My son. Our son!
It was your dress that caused all the problems.
Weren't even a dress. It was a gift for you.
Mr. Jim? Mr. Jim?
Hey.
There's a telegram messenger for you over there, near the house.
There is? Okay. Thanks, Abe. Heard you had a telegram for me?
Yes. Here. Sign there.
Thank you. Huh? Jim, stop. If you're the JM I know, stop. It's Sadie Adler. I've got something to discuss. Pay good. Meet me in saloon in Valentine. I'm there most days. Stop. Sadie Adler. I'll be damned. Abigail! Darling John, a kind lady in the village helped me write this.
She had many problems of her own, but that's a different story. Listen, I've begged you, but it don't seem to make much difference. I've tried everything I know to make you grow up. And you know I love you, but loving you means I can't watch you do this. Time after time, we've had to run because of your behavior and your decisions. We got a son. I got a son. And I love our son enough that I can't have him around while you're like this. I had so many dreams, John. I hoped you would change. We all saw what happened to them that didn't, but you... Part of you is hell-bent on ending up the same way.
And I love you too much to watch that no more. Abigail.
Where's the wife, Milton?
She's out.
I saw her leaving with the boy and the bags. What's going on?
You married Mr. Dickens?
No.
That don't surprise me.
What'd she do? Catch you with a showgirl? Or hear about you shooting more fellas over by Strawberry? Just who are you, Jim Milton?
I'm a family man. I can handle a gun, sure. Them men shot at me.
Just interested, that's all.
Ain't nothing interesting, unless you find gossip about a man's marriage worthy of your time.
Guess not. There's work to be done, unless you're running off too.
I ain't going nowhere. I'm here to work. Gotta save money, get her what she wants.
What does she want?
She wants a place of her own. Said she found a plot up at Beecher's Hope.
You? A rancher? You'll starve.
Probably.
Keep yourself busy. Take your mind off it.
That's her fault.
Hey, you know, I was wrong about you. You've turned into a fine worker, Jim Milton.
Oh, thank you. Means a lot. Hey, you think I could speak with Mr. Geddes? See if maybe he's open to offering me some guidance?
I'm sure he'd be happy to hear you speak, at least.
Thank you, Mr. Dickens. Hey, son. How's that bull?
Fine, Mr. Milton.
Your father in? Could I have a word?
Sure. I'll just get him.
Pa! Hey, I'm right here. What's the problem, Milton?
Sorry for the disturbance, sir.
Oh, no problem. My wife, she just began her morning discourse on the subject of my faults. An experience I think every man can relate to.
In some ways, my wife also has issues with some of the decisions I've made. Real issues.
Hmm?
Do you believe a man can change, sir?
Where is this heading?
I guess I don't know. I've tried to be a good hand. I've worked hard to secure your property.
And for that, we are grateful.
And you've paid me well, besides. The thing is, I suppose, I need to get a place of my own, so I can prove to my wife that I've changed.
I understand.
But I ain't got much money. I ain't asking to borrow none. But maybe you could go to the bank and put in a good word so they could give me a loan?
A loan, huh?
So I can buy that place, Beecher's Hope?
Yes, I know it. Yes, of course, sure. It'd be my pleasure. But take my advice, Milton. Take your money and go buy passage on a boat. Go to Brazil and forget all about family. I'm just joking, son. Just make sure you deal with Ansel Atherton at the bank. He's a distant cousin. Here's my name. Tell him to ask me direct himself. You'll get what you need.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I was young and dumb once, too. You'll get her back.
Looking for Mr. Atherton. I'm a friend of Mr. Getty's over at Pronghorn Ranch.
Oh, yeah, Mr. Atherton is in his office. Hey, please head in.
Thank you.
Yeah. Can I help you?
I hope so. I want a loan, sir. A line of credit, so I can buy some property.
What property?
An old ranch, Beecher's Hope.
That old dump?
I know it ain't much, but I ain't much of a farmer either. But I will get there.
That is a very unusual way of asking for a loan. Mr.
Marston.
Marston.
Only folk around here call me Milton. It's kind of a joke, I guess.
A joke, huh? Which folk?
Mr. Getty's. Uh-huh. I work for him. He said that you could help me out. I mean, if you can.
So old David Getty's told you I'm the kind of man to loan a man with two names money so he can buy a rundown farm on account of his lack of farming skills, huh?
Don't sound too promising when you put it like that.
Well, how would you put it?
Sorry to waste your time, sir.
Oh, sit down. I'm sure we can figure something out. Now, of course, we'll be expecting you to make regular payments, and given a lack of much evidence you got any means of repaying, the terms won't be too great. But if my cousin vouches for you, it'll be okay with the bank.
Really?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Now, of course, we'll be expecting our money back regular as clockwork until the debt's settled. Otherwise, the farm reverts to the bank, no matter how much you paid.
I understand.
Well, why don't you go check out the land while I fix the contracts and talk to Mr. Geddes. Oh, I heard there's squatters up there. We've been having so many problems recently, they'll need clearing on.
Sure.
Well, come back when you're done and we'll fix up the paperwork.
Can I help you, friend?
Who's in charge here?
No one, mister. This is a free country.
Now that I ain't so sure about. Listen, I'm buying this land. I'm afraid you guys are gonna have to go somewhere else.
Who's this? I ain't sure. Some fancy Dan city boy says he owns this land. Or he's gonna.
Owns it?
That's what he says.
Okay. And how come we living here?
I ain't sure.
Look. Take some money. Go try and find somewhere else to stay.
You for real, friend?
Sure, take it.
You're a real gentleman. Okay, boys. Let's go celebrate.
Thanks, mister.
Ah, it's you, the man with two names and no past. Come on in. How'd you make out?
Well, let's just say there are no more squatters.
Okay. Well, I got your paperwork ready. Now, you sure about buying this place? It's really run down, and the price isn't too great.
I think it would mean a lot for my wife. At least mean I was listening to her.
Okay. Well, sign here and here. Mm-hmm. Now we own you, Mr. Marston, and we own Mr. Milton, too, and we own your property, but you can buy your freedom each week. Eventually, you will be a homeowner.
I understand.
Congratulations. You are now a real American, indebted and owned by the bank. I'm joking. They own me. They just own your property. Now, you can also use this line of credit for any home improvements you need to make, of course.
I can?
Sure. Be good, Mr. Marston. Welcome to home ownership. It's a beautiful thing. Let your wife know what to complain about. I'm just joking.
Well, it is you. Well, I never. I thought you was dead, boy. Dead.
Uncle?
The very same. Come here. I saw you going into the bank, and by the looks of things, you ain't robbed it.
I've gone straight.
Oh, bull crap.
No, for real. Well, I'm trying.
All these years, you ain't changed a bit. Maybe a little bit. I thought you was dead.
Not yet. Well, I got some things to take care of.
No, not a problem. I'll come too.
No, you don't have to.
No, I'm real sick, John.
Lumbago. It's a slow and painful death, my brother.
Evidently.
Have a little pity, will you? Huh?
Come on, then.
All right. Okay.
What do you think?
Why exactly did you buy this dump?
For Abigail?
Why? Is she an idiot?
No.
What were you thinking?
I don't know. She said she wanted it.
She ever seen it? What are we gonna farm here? Rocks?
We?
You don't have a hope here without a wise hand at the tiller.
Enough of that. Get out of here. On your way.
No. You're stuck with me. Seems I'm stuck with you. John, the rock farmer.
So, you think I'm an idiot?
No. I know you're an idiot.
Told you to leave it, Bubba.
And I thought to myself, who this little girl thinks she's telling anything to?
Enjoy your drink in peace. I ain't got no business with you right now.
What that mean?
For the last time, leave me alone.
Or what?
What that?
Get the hell out of here before she kills us all.
You!
Get out of here.
John Marston!
It is good to see you.
I thought I heard a rumor you was alive. Jim Milton, that you?
Guess I didn't do a real good job of hiding my identity. We didn't hear nothing about you.
You kill a feller up by Roanoke?
Sure did.
I thought that sounded like you and Abigail and Jack. She's
fine.
She was always so kind to me.
I'm looking to buy us a property. Beecher's Hope, west of Blackwater. I'm kind of a farmer now. And you?
Oh, you know how it is. Bounties mostly and some other stuff, good and bad. Hey, you any interest in bounties?
No, I've gone straight. Huh? Sort of.
Oh, it's legal, usually.
Then... maybe.
Come on, then.
What? Where are we headed?
Strawberry. Guy on the run from New York. Good price for him.
What'd he do?
Rob a bank.
With a gun?
No, with a pen. He's an accountant, I think.
Your telegram. You said you had something to discuss. I didn't think we'd be chasing down an outlaw.
There's something else.
What?
Micah? I think so. I heard of someone sounded like him about a year back.
Okay.
We always said, if we found him...
I know what we said we'd do. That ain't changed.
I didn't think I'd see any of you again after you left for the Yukon.
Yeah, we came back. Didn't strike it rich, as you can see. Mr. Kirk! Mr. Kirk, you in there?
Who is it?
It's just a friend. Just a friend. Come on, open the door.
I didn't do it. I didn't do it.
Open the goddamn door. Stop. Hey, that's Nathan Kirk. Oh, got him?
Oh, shut up.
Okay, then.
What you got there?
Hey. Quiet now.
Where shall I send the money? I ain't been paid yet.
Send it on my behalf to West Elizabeth Cooperative Bank in Blackwater. Pay down my loans. Might make them happy to see I've got a boss.
So I've got a couple of other leads I could use your help with if you're interested. I'm usually at the saloon in Blackwater.
I need money pretty bad, so... working hard?
It's the lumbago. Now, if I overdo it, I'll get a relapse. It's very serious.
Get up. Or get out.
Oh, you can be so testy. What is it? Constipation?
Guess you're my proof I'll never quite outrun my sins.
You got so sanctimonious in your old age, No wonder she left you. It's like rooming with the King James Bible.
Get up!
Ow! I'm getting up. Oh, no, wait, what did I have to tell you? I went into town. I got a little drunk. Oh, shit! Well, we gotta go. We gotta go to Saint Denis. Charles Smith is alive, I reckon.
Charles Smith alive? Really?
I reckon. Unless I dreamed it all, and by the sound of it, not doing too good neither. Here we are.
Come on, let's get off.
All right.
Back in Saint Denis. I never liked this place.
Me neither.
We both know what you gotta do. I'm leaving now.
He don't know the half of it.
John? You're...
I'm alive. So are you. So's he.
That's Uncle?
What are you doing?
I don't know. I'm alive.
Uncle thought maybe he was in some sort of trouble.
I don't know. I'm throwing fights for a few dollars.
Throwing fights?
Sure.
And you like that?
Of course not.
So,
let me go place a bet. Come on. Man, I thought you were dead.
Sure. Abigail's still alive too, only she left me.
Excuse me, I'd like to place a bet.
On who?
On myself, to win. Lone Wolf.
How much?
All of this.
Okay. Funny thing, I pegged you for the favorite, but the odds just got real good. What about you, sir? A little wager on the wolf here? Real redskin brave.
Give me a bet on him.
You know what to do, Senor Smith.
Charles?
Go, Lone Wolf! Kill that bastard!
Try and stay on your feet, you hear? Huh? Hit him, Lone Wolf!
What the hell?
Come on, Lone Wolf. Gotta get you the hell out of here.
Hey! Lone Wolf! Whoa! Made my month, but you also made some fellas mighty unhappy.
So it goes.
Here's your share, partner.
If we just made the bet I said we
should. So you keen on staying around here or heading off with me and Uncle?
But, John, I haven't seen you two in years.
I know. But right now, my sense is you just need to lie low.
Where?
We got a little place up past Blackwater, in the high country.
Okay. I gotta grab my baggage. I booked a steamer heading upriver. That's why I was pretending to throw the fight.
Okay, boys. I'll meet you at the bridge outside Saint Denis.
What are you doing?
Just have a few errands to run.
You're useless.
I am a deep thinker.
Be quick.
Come on. What? Careful.
Why?
Those are Guido Martelli's men.
Who?
He used to work for Angelo Bronte.
I've only been here an hour.
Hey. Come over here.
What now?
Well, you go left, I go right. On three.
Mm-hmm.
Three.
Back in time.
You couldn't have thrown that fight!
It's never just one fight.
Evidently! Here it does! Frightening!
Come on, John.
I'll drive.
Hey, yeah. Okay. Where was Uncle gonna meet us?
Over the bridge going out of town. West. If I ever want to go back, remind me that I hate Saint Denis.
Guido Martelli will happily remind you of that.
Give me some simple folk and wide open spaces. Speaking of simple...
John! Charles! You boys been all getting up to no good?
Kind of. Been getting shot at.
Well, it weren't very good shots. Come on, let's head for home. feels like old times. It's good to have the old gang back together again.
Let's just hope things don't turn out like last time.
There he goes. What'd I tell you, Charles? Boy is as sour as weak old milk. No wonder she didn't stay with you. Not even a retired $2 whore would stay with you. That's the goddamn truth. Now, you used to be decent company, but now you're worse than a snake with a toothache. All he does is whine, whine, whine.
Excuse me?
Oh, don't get all angry. It ain't gonna change nothing. You're hopeless. And I mean that literally. You got no hope. I mean, look at you. Look at this place. Your dream home. I've had better nightmares than this dream. Oh, darling Abigail. I've changed. Come live with me in an outhouse I wouldn't ask my worst enemy to take a shit in.
What are you trying to say?
It's awful. It's a dump. The house has gotta go. Get some self-respect, you miserable sack of shit. Build a house a lady'd set foot in.
The place just needs a woman's touch.
It needs leveling. No woman would touch this place. Now, I reckon these horses can have it down in a minute. Here, come on. Tie that end around the horses. You loop that end around there. Horses will pull it clean down. We good?
I think so.
All right. Well, let's get going. Put your back into it.
Almost there. Got it.
See? I told you it wouldn't be no trouble.
And now?
Now we head into town, buy ourselves a house right out of a book. Same as if it were a bicycle.
Where in town?
There's a fella by the train store. Cakes hardwood and timber.
Okay. You keep working here.
But if I don't go with you, who's gonna
just
tell you that?
Just need a bit of peace and quiet from your incessant yapping. Charles, make him work. Whip him if you have to.
Excuse me, sir. You work here?
No, I just hang around here for fun. I'm joking. How can I help you, friend?
I know this sounds crazy. Some dumb old coot I know is telling me there's these houses you can buy pre-cut.
Not crazy, friend. The very latest in modern convenience. Convenient and cost-efficient. Which house do you want? Each one is entirely unique, but also the same.
Excuse me?
Perhaps I'm going too fast, sir. Do you want to buy a house?
I think so.
I'll give you a luxurious, entirely unique pre-cut palace. And if you order today, I guarantee your home in a matter of weeks, maybe sooner.
I'll take that one.
Ah, yes, we have that one in stock.
And I already got credit from the bank.
Oh, fantastic. Now, you write your name here, and you sign your name there, and you will be the proud owner of a factory-built home.
It's that easy.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Martin. Albert Cakes, Esquire, at your service.
You boys give me a minute.
What are you doing here? Everything okay?
I'm not sure. Probably. A fella came by the farm. Got attacked on the road. He said the Skinner brothers was hanging around. Lots of them. I left Uncle armed to the teeth back at the ranch.
Who are these two?
Guns for hire. If this Skinner's about, we need them.
We ain't got that kind of money, Charles.
You want to get robbed for your house?
No, but...
Hey, these Skinners can be nasty. Come on. Mr. Devon, you're with me. Mr. Wayne, this is...
Milton. Jim Milton.
Sir, good to meet you.
We're gonna be heading up to the Manzanita Post.
Why?
The best smith around is that Norwegian fella up there.
Yeah, so they say. You boys ready?
Yes, sir, we're ready.
Good, because you're about to get shot at over a goddamn hammer.
You want to build a house with a sniper rifle, then?
I know old Niels real well. I'll get you a good deal.
Thank you, sir. All right, then. Let's go buy us some tools.
Nils, it's me. Willard Wayne.
Okay.
This is my associate, Jim Milton.
Okay.
He heard you was the best. Best smith around. He needs some tools. He's building a ranch house up at Beecher's Hope.
Beecher's Hope? Okay.
Have you got any made?
Okay.
Like I said, an acquired taste, but a heart of gold, and he's the best. You off someplace, Nils?
Okay.
So Milton is working with Cakes Hardwood and Timber in town. Should I get them to pay you and add it to his bill up there?
Okay.
Come on, let's get moving.
Okay.
All right, then. Beecher's Hope. They've been trying to sell that property for some time, hadn't they? Took a look at it myself, as it so happens. Seemed like a lot of work. Too much for me. But more power to you. Must have seen something in it I couldn't. World needs...
Whoa! Everyone find some cover! God damn! Keep your head down! All right. You alive?
No. Mr. Devon, you okay?
Yes.
Is that the last of them?
I think so.
There's more! They got the tools!
They grabbed Mr. Wayne!
All right, you stay here, guard the wagons. Charles, come on!
They got me! Help! Help me!
Mr. Wayne! Where's Wayne? Mr. Wayne!
Charles, I found the tools. Now, where's Mr.? God damn it! A few minutes ago, he was chewing my ear off.
He knew what he was getting into.
Did he?
Skinner. Everyone knows.
Except me.
Later, John.
Uncle!
I was...
You useless sack of crap.
I was keeping guard.
Really?
Whoa. What happened?
Skinner Brothers.
Bottom?
Enough.
Once this is done, I'll take Mr. Devon back to town and get poor Mr. Wayne buried.
Okay. Be careful.
Well, I will. But I'm fairly sure we scared him off for now.
Bad business. Well, we'll be safe together.
Sure. If you say so.
And John, I love you. Don't you forget that.
Those plans make any sense?
Oh, sure.
Seems easy enough, I think.
How hard can it be? But I'll tell you what I think, just to be safe. I'll do the reading and planning, and you do the building.
How did I know you'd try to weasel out of doing any work?
Oh, now, that is plain unfair. It's inaccurate and not what's going to happen. I'm simply going to use what I've got, which is a brain. Or you use what you've got, which is less of a brain.
Let's get started.
Well, first thing it says the foundation, which involves moving those heavy wooden joists. Definitely not a job for a man with terminal lumbago unless you want to dig a 6-foot-deep hole for me when the work day's over.
Don't tempt me.
Oh, here comes Charles. Maybe he can lighten the mood a little.
How'd you get on?
He'll be back, but not for a while.
Charles, dear boy, John needs help moving these joists. Now, come on. Get a move on. We gotta get started before the rains come.
You're very annoying.
He's right. We should get on with this.
Oh.
saw and a board and I'll cut it. I'll climb up a ladder with a hammer and a nail and I'll nail it. Well, we worked so hard to build a little house together. In the snow or the rain or the ice cold wind, whenever. No matter what the weather, we're together.
And I think that's everything.
John Marston, you have a home.
So do you.
Oh, I know.
And you, Charles, as long as you'll stay with us.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, to this happy home. At least till this fool gets his woman back.
My darling Abigail, I hope you and Jack are doing well. I remain a fool, and I'm sure I shall die a fool. But I'm trying very hard to be something like the man you deserve. I have done something very silly in an effort to impress you. And that is, I've purchased a home. The land you read about in the newspaper up at Beecher's Hope is now ours, and we are going to try our hand at ranching. Mr. Geddes kindly helped me buy the land. I met Uncle while I was coming out of the bank, and while I know your feelings about him, he has been enormously helpful in his own fashion. Charles Smith has also appeared and is unsurprisingly a pillar of strength. Together, we've built you a home. I hope soon to show it to you. I miss you and the boy more than I can express. Please, come back to me. Yours always, John.
Thing that this land's good for is grazing.
Grazing?
Yeah, so cows, sheep, goats. Now, goats is easy, but They taste awful.
I don't like goats. And cows, I've seen enough cows.
Yeah, sheep then. But any livestock, you're gonna need a barn.
Barn will take three of us 6 months to build.
Oh, you don't build a barn, dumbass. What do you think this is, 1785? You buy one pre-cut just like the house. This is the industrial age. The lumber fellers all have them.
That guy makes me hate the modern world.
Oh, come on.
How are we gonna pay for this?
Same way we pay for everything.
I just wish I could help you, sir. You've been a good customer, and I like you, and David Geddes likes you. This man is very annoying.
Can you just give me a few days?
Of course.
I really enjoy begging and watching you make a fool of yourself.
Well,
John! Hey!
Is that Sadie Adler? Hey.
John, how are you?
Well, hello, Uncle. Nice to see you. And you too.
Oh, shut up, you old creep.
Listen, Sadie, you got any work? I'm kind of desperate.
Work? How desperate?
I need money. A bunch of money. My debt's climbing, and
you up for a fight?
Is it legal?
Well, it's very legal, but it's also pretty dangerous. With you, it'll be fine, but I wouldn't do it on my own.
I ain't got much choice.
All right, then. Come on.
Look after him, Sadie. He's a delicate flower underneath.
All right. The painted sky tip is pretty fresh, but I don't know how long it'll stay that way. An encyclopedia salesman was up there on the property. Couldn't find the rancher, but saw a Mexican-looking feller hanging around. Now, Ramon Cortez is around those parts, split up from his gang and stuck in West Elizabeth. It's gotta be him, holed up, waiting on some out. And we're gonna get to him first.
This is Painted Sky up here.
Looks quiet. Ramon Cortez, you better be here. Let's get down and take a look.
Ramon Cortez! We've come for you!
It'll all be over soon.
You got him?
I think so. He just tried to kill me.
That's about right. Yeah, that's him. Come on. Let's get him to the sheriff.
Well done, Hal.
Found him hiding in a pile of shit.
That's about right. How you doing, Ramon?
Oh, just fine, mister. Hey, how much you want? How much any of you want? I'll give $2,000 in gold to whichever one of you sets me free.
I'm afraid it's a bit late for that, Ramon. You've been a real bad boy. Me and my boys are gonna ride you into San Denis and watch them hang you.
Okay, if you think so, mister.
Oh, I know so, Ramon. Take a seat. Help me guard them till my boys arrive and we can get them out of here.
Sure.
Spent years cleaning up this town. Last thing I need is fools like this thinking they can take us back to the bad old days.
Well, you did a good job.
Sheriff Thomas, we want our friend back. You have about 10 seconds, Sheriff Thomas, before we kill all of you fools. One.
Don't be a dumb bastard.
Two.
This is a good town now.
Three. Let them have it, boys.
Ah!
blew my jail apart. He's gone. He's gone.
Well, we brought him in. Now pay us what's owed.
He ain't here now, madam. I don't get paid unless he makes it to Saint Denis.
You want to get shot today as well as rob, mister?
Are you threatening me?
Why would we bother threatening you?
Get him back and I'll get your money. And another $50 besides.
$100.
75. I can't go higher.
Done. Let's go, Jim Milton.
So you think we can trust him?
Yeah. He'll pay up when we come back with Cortez. He's a decent fella.
If we come back with Cortez.
We're coming back with him. Don't you worry about that.
It's an odd thing, isn't it? We'll take $200 from a sheriff, who might be crooked himself, to go get a bounty. But we won't take $2,000 from an outlaw just to let him go.
If that kind of offer is tempting to you, then go right ahead. But not when you're on one of my jobs.
I never said I was tempted by it. I just said it was an odd thing. How we'd take money from one, but not the other.
Everyone's got to choose what they're loyal to. Themselves, God, the state. If a bounty hunter wants to last, the loyalty's got to be to the one that's issuing the bounties. Plain and simple. I got a reputation for honest work.
So, everyone with a price on their head deserves it, you think?
Sure. No, I don't know, usually. If I got into who deserved what, second-guessed every poster, I'd tear out all my hair before I put a rope on anyone. If the price is high enough, you got to trust there's a reason they said it.
I hope that rationale works out.
They must be camping down there.
Why are they hanging around?
Probably waiting for a boat. There's supposed to be a storm coming through, so maybe that's delayed them.
Perhaps. So what do we do now?
I'm gonna go get them.
You?
Me. You just cover me. I ain't getting you killed out there.
But it's okay for you?
I wanna die. And besides, those bastards don't look that tough. They look asleep as far as I can tell. I'm gonna go.
You sure about this? Just don't seem right.
This is my show, John Marston. Do as you're goddamn told. And shoot well.
Hey!
Damn it, Sadie. So you really want me to shoot you? You might get lucky in court. Get over here.
All right, amigo. I'm coming.
Try anything clever, you're gonna get shot.
Oh, hold your horses, chica.
Get out of there. I said, get
out of there. Easy, easy, girl.
Oh, you gave up easy a long time ago.
Hey, look out. There's more of them coming.
Hey! Estoy aquí!
Shut your goddamn mouth! Any more? Are we done?
We might just be.
Son of a bitch!
I knew you'd be back, Ramon. You just can't get enough of me.
Put them in the wagon for me, would you?
How's the jail?
Needs to get fixed up since this nice man blew a hole in it.
Yeah.
Me and the boys will ride him to Saint Denis right away this time. Come along, Cortez.
Sheriff, before you go.
I'll pay you when I deliver him.
Plus $75.
Exactly. Now, goodbye. Let's go, boys.
I'll see you soon, amigos.
Shut up.
Thanks for this, John.
You send my money to the bank for me?
Of course.
I'm supposed to be retired from this.
This? For nothing. Just a simple arrest. Money for old rope.
If you say so.
See you around, partner.
How was your holiday?
I was making money.
And to think, you call me lazy.
You've done a great job.
Well, that crew did help.
Built a house, a barn. Look at this place. I can't believe it. Thank you. Thank you both.
This calls for a drink.
Young miss at dancing school has taught the minuet to tread. Young miss at dancing school has taught the minuet to tread. But we go better when we've brought our four-tack to Cathead. Come bustle, bustle, drink about, and let us merry be. Our can is full, we'll pump it out, and then all hands to sea. When horn and hounds the forest rend, his pack the huntsman cheers. When horn and hounds the forest rend, his pack the huntsman cheers. As loud as halloo when we send a broadside to Mount Sears. As loud as halloo when we send a broadside to Mount Sears. Come bustle, bustle, drink about, and let us merry be. Our can is full, we'll pump it out, and then all hands to see. What's got at sea we spend on shore on sweethearts and our wives. What's got at sea we spend on shore and sweethearts and our wives. And then my boys hoist sail for more, thus passes sailors' lives. And then my boys hoist sail for more, thus passes sailors' lives. Come bustle, bustle, drink about, and let us merry be. Our can is full, let's drink it out, and then our hands to sea. Yeah!
John! Get out here! Uncle's gone!
He's fine. Let me sleep.
Get out here now!
That fat man will be fine.
No, he won't. Skinners.
You think?
Of course. My guess is they went that way. But my other guess is they know we're coming after them.
What choice do we have?
None. We just gotta keep our wits about us. We know this is a trap.
Up here. You see that? Blood.
Dear Lord.
They've gone up towards tall trees. Come on!
My God! We gotta go get him.
Careful. Where are they? Where are they?
I don't care. Come on! Charles!
Behind you! All right, Jim!
What have they done to you? We gotta get you down.
Okay, we've got some time. Let's get Uncle!
You're okay, old man.
I look okay.
You look awful. You'll be okay. Those bastards. We got him. Looks like we got here just in time. God damn it.
I'll carry him.
I think it looks worse than it is.
Burns don't always heal easy.
Sure, but I think this will be fine. As long as it don't get infected. It's much better than I feared.
Hear that, old man? This could have been worse.
He's pretty weak.
Yeah, I bet. Stay with us, you old bastard.
I can't hit my back.
Let's get you down. Be easy. I got you.
Come on. Let's get him out.
Thank you, boys.
Don't mention it.
I thought
I was dead.
Don't get all sentimental now, old man. And I really think you're dying. It's gonna be okay. A few days, you're gonna be just fine. You're a survivor.
Easy, easy.
Okay. He'll be fine.
You think they'll be back?
Maybe, but I doubt it. We must have killed most of them. Now, this is your land.
Was it theirs once?
I don't think so. I met a fellow said the Skinners rode down about 2 years ago. They're just angry men on a rampage, and we got in their way.
Sort of like we used to be?
Yeah, exactly like we used to be.
Maybe we should take up torture.
We got Uncle singing instead of torture. We're gonna be safe here, John. Hmm? You, your family, you all be safe.
I hope so. I really do. If she ever comes back.
He always did have that fine way with words.
You doing all right, son?
Sure, Pop. Can I go see the house?
Sure.
Just give him some time. He'll warm up. It's quite a place you got here.
It's yours.
Ours. I should see about that boy.
Who's my new rival?
Oh, that's Rufus. He's loyal, dumb, and angry, so we reminded us of you.
That's your idea of a joke, miss?
I guess.
Come on!
So you happy?
I think so.
And I did good?
You did good.
So, am I forgiven?
Never.
You are a hard woman.
Ma! Pa! Come out here!
Sadie, you're alive! John, it's...
Sadie Adler.
Well, how'd you know she was...
I'm sorry. I thought I...
You look well. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Well, come on. But tell me about you, darling. All armed to the teeth like that.
I'm a working woman, Abigail. I'm a bounty hunter, bodyguard. I protect the gold prospectors up in the hills. I'm thinking of starting my own transportation business. I was thinking maybe if... John wanted to earn some money.
My husband, he ain't looking for that kind of work.
Took on a lot of debt when we bought this place.
And you're working for her to pay it off?
Yes, sometimes I was.
But I thought we said no more of that.
No, you said that. What else am I gonna do? I'm a goddamn man.
It's legal work, Abigail. And I never got killed. It's hunting down fools for the government. Easy. Even Jack could do it.
Don't you put those stupid ideas in the boy's head. He's gonna do something better than this.
Like what? Writing silly stories?
I'm sorry, Abigail. Really, I am. I just
thought if you wanted to earn some money.
How many times do I gotta bury you, John Marston?
Never. You ain't never burying me. It's legal work that I can handle.
There's something else.
Micah?
Bounty hunting is one thing, but goddamn Micah?
I heard he was upcountry, or some fellow who sounded just like him. Killed a family, bar a little girl who escaped.
Leave Micah alone.
Listen, I'm sorry, Abigail. I came by because I was riding by chasing a fella, and I thought John wanted to earn some extra money.
What is it?
Abigail, we need the money.
Some fella robbed his business. You know, an accountant or something. Came down from Rhodes, I believe.
How much does it pay?
It pays good. Well, the soft ones usually do.
Okay, then. I guess. But Micah? No.
All right. John Marston, let's go.
Just you bring him back to me. You hear?
Of course. Abigail's back with the boy. You must be so pleased, John. And the ranch? You were right. It's really something.
I think I'm gonna ask her to marry me. I got a ring. It was Arthur's. I found it in a bundle of things that I've kept.
You're marrying Abigail. Or asking her, at least. Oh, my. I never took you for a romantic.
No, me neither. But it's something I've thought about. And I think I know I want it.
Okay. I guess I thought you were married already, long ago.
No, not really. Not officially.
Well, I'm real happy for you, John. Being married, it made me real happy.
It all makes sense now. No, damn well does it.
Dutch! Left me! Left me to die! My boy.
I didn't have a choice.
John, I didn't. You!
I didn't have a choice.
Left me!
What is going on, Dutch? What is happening to us? What's happening to you?
You show him some respect.
It's the vandalism!
Of others. It's walk or work, old man.
I got lumbago.
You'll have more than that in a minute.
Oh, John, tell her about my health.
Do what the lady says.
I worked my fingers to the bone building this place, Abigail Roberts.
Marston! Abigail Marston. Miss Marston to you.
Miss Marston to you.
Why you let him stay?
He's actually been pretty useful in a useless sort of way.
Who's that?
No idea.
Friend or foe?
We'll soon find out. It's the Gettys boys.
From Proghorn Ranch?
Yeah.
Mr. Milton! Mr. Milton!
Duncan!
Sir, Ma found some old furniture in the attic. Pa thought maybe you folks wanted as a housewarming present, you know? They send their regards.
How kind they are. Tell your mom and pa we're very touched.
Where would you like the furniture?
Just over here. Then we can arrange. This is real kind of y'all.
You saved the ranch. Pa said this is the least he could do.
Well, that's about everything.
Send your pa my best regards. Tell him he's got friends for life in me and my family.
Bye, sir.
Ma'am?
I can't believe this. It's so kind.
Sure. But there's still some more things that we need to get.
How about we take a ride into town? It's been ages since we spent any time together.
It has. Let's go get the wagon. May I help you, my lady?
Oh, John. What would you like to do?
Maybe get our portrait took, for starters.
Portrait?
There's a feller in town takes photographs.
You want to stare at a portrait of yourself all day long? I hate to break it to you, but you ain't that much to look at.
No! I want a picture of us. Me and you. Okay?
Okay, then. Sure. Is there anything else you want?
I don't know. Let's just walk around and see where it takes us.
I do have to be back by dinner time.
Uncle Jack and Charles will manage fine without you. Hell, looking after themselves may even be good for them.
They'll starve.
And that may be good for them, too. Any luck, Jack and Charles will eat Uncle.
Don't get my hopes up. So maybe you're right. We'll stay.
You know I am.
Okay, then. Portrait it is.
Let me help you down.
Why are you being so courteous?
I don't know. There you go.
I'm gonna head to the draper's for a minute. Won't take long, but I need to get some materials. You want to come with me or wait here?
And after that, we can go get our photo taken?
Yeah, after that, we can get our photo taken. All right, let's get that picture taken. It means that much to you.
It does. Today it does.
Hello, madam. Sir.
Hello, sir.
How can I help you?
We'd like to get our photo taken.
Oh, a photo. Yes, yes, that I can help you with. Yes.
So, what do we do?
I'm sorry, what did you want?
Our portrait taken.
Oh, well, we do that. Yes, wonderful. Handsome couple, quite something, but you need a background.
A background?
Yes. We have Niagara Falls, Paris by night. We have Mount Vesuvius and its ruins. We have the open prairie. Take a look. Pick one. Wonderful. That will be simply perfect. You know, I wish I had the Congo River, but they require grass skirts. I couldn't afford them. It's just so exotic. You stay there. I'll make a pose that you feel comfortable with.
Well, this is dignified.
Try to enjoy it.
I think I'd rather be cleaning the outhouse.
Be quiet.
I thought you were a cowboy, not a poser.
Oh, no. I'm a poser. I learn from the best.
That is true.
How's this?
Perfect! Now, give me a minute. I'm going to develop this for you. Wait here.
Take your time. What?
Nothing. Nothing at all. Tough guy. Gunslinger.
Excuse me?
Nothing. I didn't say anything. I just posed.
Shut up. You know, you're not very nice to me.
Oh, I'm nicer than you deserve.
True.
Here. Came out beautifully.
Sure. Yeah.
Oh, look at that face on you.
Be quiet. What do I owe you?
$5.
There you go.
Thank you. I'll see you again.
Oh, yes. He'll probably come in for a pose. He seemed to enjoy himself. Bye now.
What shall we do now?
There is one thing I hadn't done. I've never been to see one of them moving picture shows.
Never?
No.
Well, come on. Let's go do that.
You sure?
Of course. It's the marvel of the age.
I love marvels. Thank you again.
Come on in. A mystery awaits.
Looks so real.
It's not.
Don't be such a sourpuss. Shh. Stop it.
She's a piece of work.
Really?
Shh.
All right. We better get home.
Oh, we never get out. The farm will be fine.
The farm. I love hearing that.
Let's go down to the lake for a minute.
The lake?
Sure.
Why, you finally gonna drown yourself?
In a manner of speaking, I guess I am. Happily so.
You're a silly man, John Marston.
What about Jim Milton?
Oh, he's even worse.
Let me help you in.
Like I said, mighty strange.
I like to row.
Since when? You can hardly swim.
I don't plan on capsizing.
I wonder whose boat this is.
It don't matter. We'll have it back. Will you? Will you marry me?
Get up. I am married to you.
No, I mean proper. In front of God.
You serious?
I got this ring. I've had it for a long time. Take it.
You serious?
It would make me very happy. If you would...
We've lived a lot of lives.
Let's just live this one from now on. You and me, Jack, a family, by law.
John, I didn't know it mattered to you.
It didn't. But now it does. If you think this is dumb... I'm sorry.
Shut up, you silly man, and kiss me.
With the Red Dragon dead, and Princess Breya rescued, Sir Galsworthy put down his sword and took up his plow. He became the greatest apple farmer in the kingdom. men used to travel all across Europe to eat his remarkable apples. But deep inside, he missed the dragons almost as much as they gave him nightmares. He and Princess Brea raised 7 happy children, and none of them ever knew that their father had once been the bravest warrior in the world. The end.
Love it. I truly love it. Abigail, dear, what's for dinner?
What's for dinner? Away with you, you no-good parasite. You cook.
Actually, that's not a bad idea.
John, come out here.
Hey, John. Abigail.
Sadie.
Charles. I found him. I found Micah.
No.
I got a lead. One of his boys wanted for murdering a woman. Been seen drinking in Strawberry. If we can get to him, he'll lead us to Micah. But I gotta go now. You coming?
No. He's not coming.
I will.
That's your business. His business is here.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll ride with you.
No, I'm begging you. No! You risk all this? For what? For Micah?
All this? All this wouldn't exist if it weren't for Arthur, Sadie, and all the folks as fell. If I let him go, this place ain't no more real than one of Jack's dragons.
I'm begging you.
And I'm begging you to understand. This is it. This is...
Please.
Please try to... I ain't got no other choice. Keep an eye on the place for me.
Of course.
Please!
Let's go kill this son of a bitch, then.
We owe this to Arthur.
You think Arthur cared about revenge? I'm not so sure. Especially not at the end.
He cared about stopping Micah, and that's what we're doing.
I hear you're taking bounties now.
And I hear you're building houses.
Mm-hmm. When I'm not killing old friends.
Hell, nowadays I'm almost always killing old friends. Old friends and new. Ain't that right, John?
Seems that way.
You interested in bounty hunting, Charles? My last assistant was put out to pasture.
No, that work ain't for me. I think I might get out of here. Go north. Canada. Find a woman. Start a family, if I can. I see how that life... Well, I'd like to try it.
Woo-wee, John. You're giving him the family bug.
I thought we would have inspired him to a life of celibacy and isolation.
Okay, John, Charles, you take the other side of the river. I'll stay on this board.
Cleek! Hey, Cleek! Been a while.
Shit.
Stop that man! He's wanted for murder!
Hey, I'll stop that! Stop!
Can't escape us, Cleek! Ain't no point in trying.
Hello, Cleek. Remember us?
No.
John, you gonna take a turn?
Hey, we're old buddies, ain't we?
Sure, Sadie. With pleasure. Where's Micah?
Micah? I ain't seen
him. Oh, quit squirming. Let's try this again. Where's Micah?
No.
Where's Micah?
I already told you I ain't seen him.
You lie.
It ain't my fault. He tried to kill me!
Where's Micah?
Talk, or I'll pull this lever!
Talk!
He's up in the mountains. I think he's up in Mount Hagen. He got a whole gang now. Bad man. Doing bad things. I tried to stop him from murdering that little girl. We fell out. Honest. Please, I'm one of the good guys.
Hang him.
No.
You got what you... No!
He's done.
Thank you. Naka, we're coming for you. Yeah!
This pass will take us up into the high mountains.
There must be a snapper! Get in cover! Quick!
You alive, Charles?
Just about.
Jump, be careful! Where is this bastard?
Take the shot!
You shot my friend, you... A bitch!
Okay, let's go back to Charles. Hey, you're okay. You're okay.
I will be. But go on. Go on now. Move fast. They'll come down that hill and kill us all.
Come on, John.
I don't want to leave him.
Hey, they know we're coming now. I will be fine. I'll follow you up. I just can't move fast.
Okay.
Come on, John.
Shit!
Where are you, you sad sack of shit? We can't get trapped down here!
Katie! Get your hands off her! You all right?
Just fine.
You don't look too fine.
Come on.
You're bleeding pretty bad.
Ain't nothing.
You should sit down.
I'm fine.
You're dying.
I'll be fine.
Just sit. It's okay.
I ain't dying. I ain't.
I hope not.
I ain't dying. Just go get him. I'll be fine. I just need to rest.
Okay. Charles, stay with her.
Charles, you worry about yourself. I'll be up there.
Look who it is.
In a minute.
Ain't got a habit of just showing up.
But I got something to take care of, sure.
Just you left, is it?
Yeah. Just me. I was kind of hoping I could kill you. That was Joe! We gotta be close! Micah Bell! I'm just here for Micah Bell! Where's Micah?
Hello, Scarface. Did you miss me?
Not much.
Been a few years.
How's that, whore of yours?
She's good. Didn't reckon I should waste my time killing you. But I felt different.
So it seems.
Well, maybe after all this is over, I'll go pay her a call. And the boy.
Whatever you say.
Come on now, Micah. At least die like a man.
Hellfire. It's just like old times.
Come on. You turn around.
and start walking.
You got me.
Just like old times. All manner of folk paying social calls.
Hello, son. Mrs. Adler. It's been quite a while.
Now, John. Now, what were you saying?
Let her go.
Now I can't do that, John.
Dutch. Dutch, come on now.
You shot at me, son.
You started.
You betrayed me.
I could say the same as you.
I was trying to do my best. You just cared for yourself.
I think differently. Let her go! She ain't well.
I don't want to kill you, John.
Say something, Dutch! Say something!
I ain't got too much to say no more.
He shot me. You shot me pretty good.
Thank you. You okay?
Fine.
You're crazy.
I hope so. Help me up.
Let's go get Charles.
There's money. Lots of money. In the cabin is black water.
I'll go see.
Hurry up. I got a wedding I want to go to.
Jack, Uncle, come out here!
It's over, Abigail. It's all over.
I'm going to where the sun burns in the heat stays in, come and come or lay by my side, right here, to where the river turns to dust and God is never rushed, come or lay by my side, right here, red, I love you and the world. Seemed to make sense when Brother Santo said, oh, one more run be enough, gonna be enough money for everything, Silver-toed boots and kerosene, come and lay by my side right here. Red, I love you and the world. Oh, the buzzing thick and the choking, I can't stay no more. Come and lay by my side right here. Red, I need you in the world. When I see you behind the glass, I forget that I'm in the cage. They bring me to Sunday mass, but it never wiped the rage. Red, I love you and the world. 7 months gone and 7 years to go, Reg. I can't stay no more. Come and lay by my side right here. Red, I love you and the world. Red, I need you and the world.
Thank you. battled hard, the war was won. You did your worst, you tried your best. Now it's time to rest. Now it's time to rest.
Well, you're alive.
So it would seem.
So, how do you feel?
I don't know the polite word for it.
I do. Stupid is the word we use around here. What were you doing?
I was doing something stupid.
Well, you'll be okay. Once you didn't die, the doctor said you'd be fine. He got the bullets out a couple days ago.
Good.
It cost us $15.
I'm sorry, madam. Should have left me there to die.
Did you want to die? I mean, was that it? Was that why you went straight out to Fort Mercer and picked a fight with the worst bandit in the county? To die,
Mr. Marston. John Marston.
Bonnie McFarlane. Miss Bonnie McFarlane.
Well, you may be right, Miss McFarlane. I don't know.
Huh. So what were you doing?
Trying to give Mr. Williamson a chance, for old time's sake.
You know Bill Williamson?
Knew him, long time ago.
Well, what was he like?
Dumb.
Just like you.
Thank you, miss. Seen my hat?
I have. And, what will you do now?
Now I'm gonna take my time and go after him the less kind way.
Well, that sounds very fun, Mr. Marston. Quite heroic, just like in those penny dreadfuls my brother used to read. Meanwhile, if you'll excuse me, I've got a ranch to run. Of course, if you're feeling better, why not take a ride with me later? Help me patrol the perimeter. You can earn back some of that money we wasted on doctor's bills.
Of course. And thank you for saving my life, I mean.
Next time, Mr. Marston, I strongly recommend you don't try to lose it quite so earnestly.
I'll bear that in mind.
Ah, Mr. Marston, how are you?
Good, Miss McFarlane. How are you?
I'm well. Would you mind riding with me to Armadillo? I've got to get some supplies and I could do with the company.
Of course.
You can take the reins. It wouldn't do for a terrifying bounty hunter such as yourself to be seen driven around by a woman. So this is Armadillo. Manhattan it is not, but it does okay for us. Most important thing for you right now is getting yourself into Dr. Johnson's office to purchase some medicine. The first one's on me.
Thank you, miss. I'll pay you back.
I'm sure you shall. The doc's a good fellow. He saved your life, so be polite to him. Meet me in front of the general store when you're done. Well, thanks for driving me. It was nice to be able to enjoy the view for once, and a little company never hurts now and again.
You're more than welcome, miss. Least I can do. Thank you for the medicine.
Why don't you have a look around Armadillo? You can always take a stagecoach back to the ranch later.
I might just do that. Travel safely, miss.
Try not to get yourself shot. I won't be around to save you this time.
Excuse me.
Hey. Hey! You got a visitor.
Shut up, you. Now, what you want?
My name's John Marston. You wanted to speak to me.
I did?
Apparently so.
Why?
I guess because we're both in the business of the law.
You that fella from the train company?
No, I'm from Fort Mercer.
Fort Mercer? You them, one of them Williamson boys.
Calm down.
Go on, shoot him, mister. Shoot him.
Come what? You getting cute with me, boy?
What's going on here?
I got me one of them Williamson boys.
I got me one of them idiots who give marshals a bad name.
Jonah, put your gun down. You must be the man from Blackwater.
Yes, sir. Listen, that dog ain't too bright, but he seems loyal.
Jonah, get out of here for a minute.
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson, sir. And you? Oh, I done seen enough of your hide around here, friend.
I think there's some school children down the way you can go and frighten.
Oh, hardy fucking whore, dickhead.
What are you doing here, Mr. Marston? Apart from frightening my deputies.
I'm here to capture or kill Bill Williamson.
Okay.
Can you help me?
He's outside my jurisdiction. He's in the next county. Of course, Bill Williamson and his boys have tended to keep themselves away from my town.
So you're happy to have him out there?
Well, I ain't happy, but I also ain't suicidal. My job is to keep this town safe, not clean up all of these three counties. It's hard enough around here.
You know, I hear you speak, and suddenly I'm reminded of how some of the people I respected most in my life had a problem with authority. What's wrong with you?
Well, I'm sure you and your fine friends have enjoyed spending your time running around pursuing noble causes. My cause is to keep this town from turning into a living hell for the folks who live here. Whole world has problems, mister, and I'm here doing what I can.
Why? What's happening?
Right now? I got the railway, the people who pay my salary, trying to get me to turn a blind eye to them burning down settlements up there. I got a bunch of cattle rustlers out near Box Canyon needs shutting down. Not forgetting the gang that keeps murdering homesteaders out in the backcountry. And I got a bunch of hoods over in the saloon, drunk, threatening to shoot up the whole town. That's all I got today. But it's early yet. Give me a couple more days. There'll be more.
All right. Tell you what. Let's go deal with them hoods in the saloon. Then we'll discuss Williamson.
Okay, boy. You're a persistent little cuss, ain't you?
Only when things matter.
Mr. Marston, I've been hearing about your plans.
Have you, Miss McFarlane?
Yes, from Lee Johnson. To settle here and build a life for yourself.
I'm afraid those aren't my plans. See, I already have a life. Well, I had one, and I'm trying to reclaim it. Or maybe what you could say is that I had two, and I'm trying to end one of them so the other can survive.
You do so love to talk in riddles, Mr. Marston. Do you do that, I wonder, as a substitute for having anything interesting to say?
Probably, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, call me Bonnie, you fool. Call me Bonnie.
Miss McFarlane, I'm married. I have a son. I had a daughter, but she died. Years before that, I rode in a gang. We robbed banks, trains, held people ransom. We killed people we didn't like. Bill Williamson was in that gang. Now, if I don't capture my former brother in arms, great harm will befall my family. Now, I don't suppose any of this is very interesting to you, but I hope it explains why I wasn't so eager to talk about it.
No, I do understand. I had no idea. You poor man.
Even in this new country, memories don't really fade. My father was an illiterate Scot born on the boat into New York. He never saw his homeland, but to hear him talk about it, you'd imagine he only ever ate haggis and wore a kilt. And he hated the English for what they had done to his great-grandparents that he'd never met. People don't forget. Nothing gets forgiven.
That's true, especially when it comes to money. And you know, even now, after all his labors, my father's debts are still terrible. I worry every day about us losing the ranch. It would kill him.
My father died when I was 8 years old. His eyes were, well, let's just say he was blinded in a bar fight south of Chicago. My mother died during childbirth. She was a prostitute, and he was her, well, I don't know what he was. So I was sent off to an orphanage and ran away and fell in with a gang.
My word. What a difficult life you've lived.
The leader of the gang taught me how to read, taught me how to see all that was good in the world. He was a great man in a way.
But you killed people.
Sure. And I've suffered for it. And that's the life I left, or tried to leave. Said too much, Bonnie. I'm an uneducated killer, sent here to do all I can do well. Kill a man in cold blood so that another man may do his part to cut crime in an area, and a rich man can be elected governor on the back of these promises.
Civilization is a truly beautiful thing, Mr. Marston. Listen, can you help me?
Well, I can try. What do you need, money?
No, nothing so complicated. I need an extra hand to take out the herd to pasture.
Sure. Point me in the right direction.
John?
Marshal?
Gentlemen! It's time. We must go.
Why? What's happening?
Seth has managed to get himself inside. But we can't leave it too long, or they will soon realize how very curious he is and remove him from the premises. Slit his throat and watch him bleed to death. But for a minute, he will delight and amuse them. That's when he'll get us inside.
Okay.
Marshals of the law, when the shooting starts, take that as your cue to start awarding each other medals.
Hmm?
I mean, take that as a cue to get inside and clean up the mess.
Oh. All I care about is Williamson. It is vital we stop him.
Agreed. That man is a stone-cold killer.
Williamson's a proud fool. The question is which will win out between his pride and his instinct for survival.
Ensconce yourself in the back of my wagon, John, so that we can make our grand entrance.
Come on. Let's go.
My good men, what would you say if I said immortality was at hand? What would you say if I told you I could teach you to fly? What would you say if I told you I could turn a man into a beautiful woman? Impossible, yes, once, but no more. Gentlemen, I bring you wisdom from the East. I have here in this wagon some of the finest goods, the best medicines, and the newest inventions available for you and your families. Exotic trinkets from the far reaches of the earth, elixirs that give vigor and strength. And for you men of physical skill and athletic physique, this miraculous elixir can keep the muscles supple and relax the cords. It loosens the joints and gives a feeling of vigor and freshness to the whole system. Why, some men have reported to me that after drinking it for 1 month, they can chew through steel.
What the hell?
It's a trap!
You're all about to have hole footage!
Fucking dang pig! Them cocksucking sumbitches escaped the other side of the fort!
All right, let's go. That's the last of them. We still can't find Williamson anywhere.
Hey, it's the snake oil guy!
General Adam, let me in, for goodness sake!
That fool must be hiding.
Men, it is time to start tearing this place apart and find out where he's cowering!
You've got a sense of urgency here, please!
Open the gate! It's the snake oil guy!
What the Get the hell? Goddamn gate open and lock it behind him!
Bill ain't here. We looked everywhere.
Hold on! Hold on, I've
Marston,
missed it.
Mr. Marston, we got a live one. He says, Bill's already run off to Mexico yesterday morning.
You'll never get him.
Javier Escuela. He's gone to see Javier Escuela. That should make things interesting. Where in Mexico?
How should I know?
Oh! Where in Mexico, you little shit?
Someplace near Chuparosa, I think he said. That's bandit country.
Chupa feckin' Rosa. Well, I'll take you there, John. I'm real popular down there. You just meet me at the ferry. I've got lots of friends down south.
I'll see you at the ferry, Irish.
And just get me things.
I'm sorry about this, John. I guess you'll be heading to Mexico.
So it would seem.
Yes, well, that's what makes you such an interesting fellow, Mr. Irish. Ah, Mr. Marston, I've come to wish you well. How are you, sir?
I'm okay.
It seems that our friend, Mr. Irish here, is well connected south of the border.
Oh, it's true. They love me down there. It's like a second home. I've got more friends than you could shake a stick at, should you so desire.
So you know the way?
Oh, it's easy. We just get on me raft here and let the current sweep us away to paradise. Come on then, Dobby.
I'm not sure your idea of paradise and mine are quite the same, Irish.
Relax. We'll have a great time and we'll find your man Williamson, no bother.
I hope so.
Hey, come on now. Look at it this way. I know we ain't exactly old pals, but, you know, have I ever done you wrong?
No, but not through lack of trying.
Hey.
Well, you boys have fun down there. I shall miss you, John Marston.
Thank you. Where are you headed?
Oh, me? Oh, London or Paris or maybe Peking. I'm a traveling man, sir. This land is much too small for the likes of me.
Well, try not to get yourself killed.
Oh, well, yes, we men of science are not a very loved bunch in this land of myth and superstition. I'm off to the civilized world, where men like myself are revered and given medals. Ha!
Have fun.
The same to you, sir. The same to you.
Oh, these horses look fresher. Whoop! And healthy.
Before you degrade these poor fools any further, tell me where I'm headed.
Of course, of course. Let me think.
You do know people down here, aside from your friends who welcomed us on the way.
Yes, I think so. I was real drunk last time I was here, John. You know how it is. I met an American guy, saw him shoot a man. Drank with him in the village of Chuparosa. Funny guy. Or was that Canada? No, that was Canada. Guy here, not funny, but he's real nice. Failing that, you could try the provincial governor, Colonel something or other, some Spanish name. He's based out of Escalera. Played three-card stud with him. Or was it four-card Monte? I forget. He was a real nice chap, or maybe he was a real bastard. I was real drunk last time, John.
Well, thanks a lot for your help. Oh, let me guess. You gotta be on your way.
The famed hospitality isn't what it once was, and I've never been known to overstay me welcome. So off I go to greener pastures. Good luck, John. You're an angry and a feck ugly man, but not a bad one.
Con el otro. No interrumpas, pendejo, la dejé en la casa. Y les digo, de aquí para acá, chingan a su madre. ¿Qué? ¿Y qué nos da? Cállese, güey. Y de aquí para acá, son pendejos.
¡Hey, gringo! ¿Hablas español?
No, sir. Pardon, pero yo habla un solo poquito español.
Poquito.
¿Habla inglés?
Oh, sí, gringo. Hablo mucho inglés. Y hablo filthy fucking bean eater. Hablo slippery little Mexican. Oh. Hablo little piece of shit. Shit. ¿Comprende, amigo? ¿Comprende? Hey, what are you doing here, gringo? I don't remember inviting you to my country.
I don't think you did, amigo. I mean you no harm.
You mean us no harm? This is funny. What harm could you do to us exactly?
Nothing, amigo. Now, I appreciate the welcome committee, but I'd hate to spoil a beautiful afternoon on such beautiful land. Any further unpleasantries? Now, if you'll excuse me.
Hold it, gringo. I think you're forgetting something. A little taxation. I have a large family.
Very big.
I, too, have a family friend. So that we may see our families again, I suggest we part ways amicably.
Can I see the boots, gringo?
I think you can see them from where you're standing just fine, senor.
Take off the boots, Americano.
As you wish.
Oh, very good. Very good indeed, sir.
What a great way to improve border relations. An illiterate farmer crossing the river, coming into their civilization and butchering the local peasants? Thank you very much, sir.
Don't mention it, old man.
You kill peasants, you become a peasant.
I never aspired to be anything more.
A socialist, huh? No wonder you left America.
I'm many things, most of them bad. But a man of political principles? No.
Well, then I fear Mexico may not be for you, sir.
Don't you worry about me.
Oh, but I do worry. An angry man a long way from home, a man who handles a gun as sloppy as you.
I can handle a gun okay, partner.
As long as you're killing quail or peasants. But if you have to face another man, you don't stand a chance.
And you do?
I can show you a few tricks. Come with me.
Hold on. What's your name?
That doesn't matter anymore. And you?
I never had a name, mister. I was raised in an orphanage.
A real American, huh? Wonderful. Just wonderful. Well, you won't make it in the circus, but you can shoot. Keep on practicing.
Thank you, old man.
Now, who are you?
No one interesting. Who are you?
Landon Ricketts. Not a name that means much anymore.
Means a little. You were famous when I was a boy.
Yeah, killing men's a strange kind of fame. I was the fastest in my time. I must have been. I'm the only one left.
What are you doing here?
Living quietly. Waiting.
For what?
I don't know. And you?
I'm looking for a couple of men. Bill Williamson, Javier Escuela. Escuela's from here.
It could be. This whole place is teeming with Americans on the run. Mercenaries, locals hell-bent on revolution.
Revolution? Another one?
Yeah. Never really ends. This whole place has been a hotbed for revolution since before the Spanish left. Now there's another local guy running around promising the peasants their freedom. Ah, just like the last two or three. Local government? Foul bunch. Colonel Allende, he runs this place like a feudal king. He's an awful individual.
Is that so?
Yeah. Until someone puts a bullet in his head. Come on, let's get back to it. You gotta keep that back straight. Otherwise, it makes the gun jump. Hey, gringo.
Mr. Ricketts.
Come on in. Sit down and have yourself a drink.
Sure. Say, any word of Javier Escuela?
No, nothing yet. Say, why are you after him anyway?
We're old friends. We was kind of educated together.
So what is this, some kind of high school reunion sort of thing?
Something like that. Well, you've killed people. You lived the life.
That I have.
And I tried to stop. I mean, I don't know. I tried to go straight. I did. I left the gang after the gang left me. Left me to die after I'd been shot. They'd all gone crazy anyhow. Our old leader, fella you probably heard of. Anyway, he more or less lost his mind, went and shot a bunch of people unfair-like. I got shot in a robbery. They left me, and I left them.
Well, that's how it goes.
Already had me a woman, got me a farm, then I got me more trouble.
Sure.
Been sent to track down the men I used to run with. Track them, kill them.
Well, if you don't, someone else will. There's no escape. Look at me, I spent 25 years killing men. Look at me now, sitting around here like some low-rent would-be messiah. We're relics. Come on, have yourself another drink and let's wallow in a little self-pity.
Sounds like a plan.
Your health.
Mr. Ricketts! Mr. Ricketts! Thank the Lord I have found you. And you, Mr. Marston.
You sit down. You all right?
I'm well, sir. But Allende is sending more men to the death. Prisoners who have not been tried. A prominent writer, Castilla, and a local official whose only crime was not putting the small holders on the street when they were late with taxes.
Writers and government officials. For once, I agree with Allende. Some men need to be killed.
Mr. Ricketts!
I was just joking. Where are they?
Out near Escalera.
Let's hang up our self-pity and go shoot ourselves some bad guys. You're gonna be all right.
Thank you. Both of you.
I will handle it from here. I know you got other matters to attend to.
It's been nice riding with you, Mr. Ricketts.
And you too. You took me back to another time. Talk to Louisa. She'll help you, and she's well connected in that other land. I hope you find what you're looking for, Marston.
You know what I'm looking for.
If you say so, Marston. If you say so.
Está bien, mamá. Está bien.
No. No.
Ah, señor Marston. Mamá, papá, este es el gringo que me salvó.
Muchas gracias. My family is indebted to you. Forgive my English.
What's happening?
Great and terrible things. The revolution is coming. The country will be in turmoil once more. This time, we hope it's the last time.
Does that seem likely?
With Abraham Reyes, anything is possible.
Where's your family going?
My parents and my brother are headed to the hills. My sister has to flee. The army have an unfortunate way of treating women.
And you?
Don't worry about me, Mr. Marston. I'm living in history. I'm not afraid to die.
Your nobility is almost as affecting as your naivete.
I would rather be dead than a cynic like you, Mr. Marston.
I would too.
I know you're not really like that. You saved me.
Luisa, ¿quién va a salvar mi Miranda? Tenemos que llevar al puerto su barco, sale al anochecer, no queda tiempo.
Mr. Marston, can I ask one more favor of you? Can you take my sister to the docks? We are sending her to work for a kind man in the Yucatan. She's too young for revolution.
Okay. Anything I can do to help out?
The boat leaves at sundown. Miranda, vamos.
Oh, adiós, Miranda. Ten cuidado.
Adiós. Te amo.
Gracias a Dios.
Travel safely.
Oh, Mr. Marston. Mr. Marston.
What's wrong, Louisa?
I don't weep for myself, but for my country. Abraham Reyes has been captured.
He has?
He was coming to meet me at Roca Madera. It's a very romantic spot. It was a beautiful night, yet he was ambushed by patrol. My heart is breaking, but I cry for Mexico.
Where is he being held?
El Presidio. You know, in our hearts, we are married already, but his family do not approve. How could they, when I'm little more than a peasant girl? But that's what makes Abraham the man he is. He doesn't care for their bourgeois snobbery or elitism. He sees the real me, the woman.
I'm sure.
I'm going to go and rescue him or die trying.
Oh, whoa, whoa. I don't think that's such a good idea. Ride with me to near the jail. We'll figure out how to rescue him.
Mr. Marston, you are truly a friend of this land.
So everyone keeps informing me.
Luisa sent me. We have to meet her by the river.
¿Qué?
Luisa, the girl you're marrying.
Oh, yes. Such a devoted thing. El amor de mi vida.
Abraham, Mr. Marston.
Oi!
The revolution will live on thanks to you.
Yes, indeed, John. You are as a brother to me. And my people need a man such as you to help our cause. My ranch is in Agave Viejo, and let me say, my brother, that we await you.
Well, best of luck to both of you, but I need to find two men so I can return to America.
No problem. I will help you find those men. And in return, you will win a people her freedom.
Viva Mexico!
¿Para dónde tú vas, bella? Bye, John. Vente conmigo. Tú sabes que en esta luz puedo ver el fuego en tus ojos. Laura, dame la fuerza para luchar. ¡Por puta, qué chingado!
¡Viva México!
¡Qué rico! John, excuse me. Oye, mamita, cuando te vea la próxima vez, que sea un poco más durito, ¿eh? And I mean rougher, ¿eh?
What would your most loyal follower, Luisa, say about that?
Who?
Luisa, the girl from Campo Morada?
Her, I... A gentleman never tells, but she was a most wonderful... I just say she was increíble. Yes. Let me tell you something. I strongly recommend her. You take her when you have the chance, my brother.
She thinks she's your wife.
My wife? These peasant girls, they believe every word a fellow says. So naive. It's really quite charming. I love peasants. Don't you love peasants? I love them. They have such... purity.
Are you gonna marry her?
Ha! Marry a peasant? My dear boy, don't be absurd. I'm going to be the next president of Mexico. My wife will meet ambassadors, kings, other great men. The very thought that I would marry some peasant girl with a tight gun and the hands of a farmer, well, I really don't think so. My mother, que Dios la cuide, would turn in her grave.
Interesting.
But come on, let's run. I've got an amazing present for you, my brother, huh? Yes? The man you seek. Together, we will bring them to justice. Let's go. My men will launch a ruse attack on the side entrance to the fort. Meanwhile, you, my American friend, will drive this wagon at the front gate and jump off when you are close. It's been packed with 5 crates of TNT.
That sounds crazy. How long's the fuse?
Yes, like I say, fun times. It's plenty long enough, I think. I see you in there, amigo.
No se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca. Ay, 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 canta y no llores, porque cantando se alegra el cielito lindo los corazones.
Hello, old friend. It's been a long time.
Hello, brother. It's good to see you. I heard you was coming. You took your time, no? Come on, you're not gonna shoot your own brother, are you? We was family.
Yeah, we were. Then you and Dutch went crazy, and family didn't mean so much.
So now you do the government's work.
And what do? You just work for a different government.
Come on, brother. I think we should go our separate ways, huh?
What you and Dutch did was wrong. And the way you left me was wrong. Now, I hate to judge, but as it turns out, it's you or me.
The way I see it, might as well be you.
We thought you was dead, brother. I promise. I'm telling the truth. Besides, I can give you Bill. And Dutch. Dutch is in Colombia. I can take you straight to him. Hmm?
You left me to die? Whoa. To save your own skin, and now you expect me to care about you?
You got it all wrong, brother. I've always loved you. Even now.
Mr. Marston, fancy seeing you down here. Well, it is a pleasant surprise, I must say.
He's not looking very healthy. We told you to keep them alive.
You should be glad to have them at all.
Just remember your obligations to the government, Mr. Marston.
We need you to find Williamson, then head to Blackwater as quick as you can. We have reason to believe that Dutch Vanderlind is in the area.
Your wife sends her regards.
Voltealo, voltealo. Quítate, estúpido. Le voy a dar un balazo. Quítate. Quítate, pendejo. Quítate. Una, dos, tres. ¡Bang! ¡Bang!
¡Todo por la revolución! ¡Vamos,
México!
¡No, para atrás, para atrás! ¡Usted para atrás! ¡Para atrás!
¡Escuchen, rebeldes! ¡Escuchen cómo cantan los
tíos! ¡Otra vez!
Welcome to Mexico. My brothers and I are just discussing the future of our country.
Okay, let this man go.
And who are you, gringo?
I'm no one. But unless you want this town to tear you and your boys to shreds, I suggest you let him go.
And you think you could tell me what to do, friend?
Oh, you should listen to him, friend.
Look at that. You want to risk it?
The American is a drunk. If I were you, I would pull that trigger.
Put the gun down, Americano.
Ya, ya, mátalo.
Dejen mi hombre.
Mierda. Huh? Ay, Dios mío.
Santa Maria!
So you want to settle this now, friend? Or you want me to shoot you in the head right now for that poor girl?
Okay, but we fight like men, not like dogs.
Stay off the pass.
We can still get to my stagecoach!
Go then! I'll cover you!
Vámonos! ¡Date prisa, cabrón!
What the hell are you doing? Find my freedom, pendejo! Now shut up, you dumb ape! And get out of the wagon! Apúrate!
I'm coming out! Don't shoot!
Here! Take Williamson! Just let me live!
You always was weak-minded!
You're the one who let Dutch drive you insane!
Dutch wanted you dead! We all did!
Well, I'm going after him next! I'll outlive all of you!
You always was a traitor! You bastard orphan!
Now let me go! Allende is dead! Mexico is mine! My people are free, and it is all thanks to you, John.
And to the people who laid down their lives. People like Luisa.
Oh, yes. She's very brave, and she will be missed. Who is she?
Your peasant girl wife-to-be?
Oh, yes, of course. She will have a day named after her. Laura's Day.
Luisa.
What?
Oh, yes, I knew Laura as well. Magnificent girl. Like riding a pompous bull, it was, amigo. You never saw anything like it. Anyway, enough about sport. Let's get back to politics. I trust you will join us in riding on the Capitol.
I'd love to, but with Williamson dead, my jailers need me back in Blackwater.
Hey, ¿qué hacen? Levántense. Well, I must say, I'll miss you, John Marston.
I doubt you'll even remember me, Abraham, but it's been an experience. Good luck with the revolution. If you win power, remember why you wanted it.
Well, travel safely, amigo. Vamos.
I'm here to see Mr. Ross.
107, 109.
Edgar Ross.
113. Upstairs on the right. 114. 115. 116. 117.
Mr. Marston, so glad to see you. How was your journey?
Where's my wife and son?
Being well looked after. Well looked after.
I want to see him.
Mr. Ross wants to speak with you. We've had some important developments.
You want me to take out a gun and blow a fucking hole in your head right here? Right now? You want that?
Mr. Marston.
You want that?
Mr. Marston, I ask you to calm down.
Why? Why? I did what you asked. I got you Williamson and Escuela. It's over. Stop playing games with me.
No one's playing games with you, Mr. Marston. But if we were to play some games, there'd be some interesting ones we could play.
Thanks, sir.
Like hanging you for murder, or confiscating all of your property, like that little farm of yours, or having you put in an electric chair. Those are the sort of games we could play. But we choose to play a different game. So calm down and play along with us.
Where's my wife?
You know, I forget, but I hear it's very nice this time of year. Mr. Marston, please, I've never insulted your meager intelligence. Do not insult mine. We've done this little deal for your freedom in exchange for all your men from your old gang. You gave us Williamson and Escuela. We still don't have Vanderlyn, but now we know where he is.
Then go and shoot him.
No, sir. I want you to shoot him for me. And then I'll let you be. The last thing I want to do is make martyrs out of all these people. He could be killed by some petty squabble by another lowlife.
We believe Vanderlyn just holed up with a group of renegades near the wreck of the Serendipity Riverboat.
Ah, yes. Another group of renegades. Obviously, the first group, your group, has, shall we say, been disbanded?
Disbanded.
Anyway, Mr. Ford and Mr. Marston, shall we go? Oh, Mr. Marston, your wife and son are doing well. Let's both try to ensure things stay that way.
Okay? After you, sir.
Oh, Mr. Marston, one more thing. This is for you.
You're too kind.
See, I have nothing but your best interest at heart.
Let's hope it doesn't go off by mistake.
343.
I have a patent for that, sir. This is an outrage. Ah, Mr. Marston. You're alive.
Hello, Wes Dickens. Thought you were headed to Peking.
So did I, in a long story. But now it seems I'm being put under arrest and charged with narcotic possession or some other such nonsense.
Ross, have him release this man.
Why?
Because he's a harmless old fraud, the kind of man that built this country. And because he helped me get Williamson.
Did you hear that, officer? The man's a hero. Let him go. Come on, Marston. Moral degeneracy waits for no man. Let's hurry along.
3:44, 3:45, 3:48, 3:00. Isn't this something? Lawmakers and lawbreakers working together for the good of civilization.
Like you always say, sir, the higher the stakes, the smarter you have to play the game.
I can't imagine I ever said anything quite so trite. In any case, I'm not sure Mr. Marston would agree with us.
Unfortunately, Mr. Marston isn't broad-minded enough to appreciate the unique opportunity we're offering him.
Son of a whore.
You best watch your damn mouth!
And it's strange you should say that, Mr. Marston, because according to my files, you are the whore's son. Now, what else can I recall from the files? Ooh, let's see. You killed hundreds of innocent people. You've robbed at least 40 banks that we're aware of.
They told us there was a prize when you got to 50.
I'm glad this is all such a joke to you.
I want my family.
And I'm sure all the men you murdered wanted their families too. Come now. You're stupid. But you're not that stupid. We both know how this has to be. And it could be all over today. As soon as we find Dutch Vanderlyn, you can go back home and play being a farmer again, or whatever else you've been pretending to do for the last few years.
First it was Bill, now it's Dutch. After Dutch, it'll be somebody else. Where does it end?
It ends when we say it ends. You're in no position to make demands.
Like you will. You don't just walk away from that. Buy a few chickens and make it all disappear. You should be dead or rotting in a jail cell by now. We are giving you a chance at new life. A chance at redemption. You can't erase your past, Mr. Marston, but we can.
Over here! I found him!
Good God, that's our informant! Nostis, what the hell's going on here? So, this is the office of an anthropologist named McDougal. He was thrown out of Yale for a degeneracy.
We should tell you something.
Indeed. But he's been helping us deal with the natives in this area.
They see him and they presume we're all idiot academics.
Huh? Give me a hand here, Marston.
Ah, Mr. Ross. Mr. Fordham? Good day. Good day. What on earth's going on here?
Kid got shot in the leg. Beat up pretty good.
We'll send a doctor. Now, McDougal. Mm-hmm. We need information from this fellow about Dutch Vanderlyn. Can you see what you can find out for us?
Do my best, sir.
Make sure you do.
Professor McDougal has been a good friend of the U.S. government, Mr. Marston, just like you. Why don't you see if you can help him in his study of the native problem in this county? That's a good thought.
Incredible. Simply incredible.
Hello, Professor.
Hello, sir. Oh, Mr. Marston, sir. Good day, good day. How are you?
What a pleasant surprise, Mr. Marston. An informant just told us some interesting news. Our mutual friend, Mr. Vanderlyn, is about to pay call on his bank manager. What do you say to having a little financial discussion with the fellow? This way.
Let's get up on the roof. We'll have a clear shot at them from there. That door is the only way in and out of the building, so cover it tight. You see those horses to the left by the building across the street? Dutch's boys hitched them there. They'll have to run that way to make their escape. Don't start shooting until they're out in the open. If we spook them, they might retreat back and hole up inside. Don't shoot till I give you the signal. Keep your sights trained on that bank door. Marston, head into the bank with Hopkins and Manny. Get Dutch. Be careful. There may be some innocent people there.
Take him!
Oh, it's nice to see you, John.
Hello, Dutch.
How's Abigail?
Well, I hope.
Ain't seen her for a while.
Because you've been chasing me?
Let the woman go, Dutch.
Of course. Of course. How's your little boy?
He ain't so little now.
No, he must be what? 15? 16? Doesn't time fly?
Don't adjust. It's over, man.
Of course. Of course. I surrender, John. You're the master now.
I've been my master since you left me to die.
We all make mistakes, John. I never claimed to be a saint. But equally, I never took you for an errand boy.
Just trying to help my family, Dutch. By making compromises, we all have to. Now let her go. It's over.
You want the girl, John? You always were the romantic sort. You know, gentlemen, this man here, oh, he married a whore. Used to ride with us. We all had her. But he married her. And you know that makes him a better man than us. He's a better man. Have the girl, John.
Easy, Dutch.
She's a parting gift from me.
No! God damn!
Where's Dutch, Marston?
He got away.
Scared to shoot him? Too much to handle?
When the opportunity presents itself, I'll put a bullet in him, don't you worry. Won't like myself for doing it, but I'll do it.
Good man, good man. You know, at the end of this, you'll probably get a medal. I know I shall.
Professor!
Oh, it's you, dear boy. Come in, and shut the door.
What's going on? You leaving?
Yes, sir. Yes, I am, sir. Do you know the thing? The thing that is vital, without which scholarship cannot proceed, sir?
No, I don't.
Not having a bullet in your flipping neck, sir. I'm not cut out for this. No, not cut out for this at all.
Nope.
They're fucking savages! Savages!
I think we all are.
Not me, sir. I'm from Connecticut. I'm a professor at Yale. I write books. I do not deserve to die out here. Where's my tincture? Oh, yes.
You okay, Professor?
Oh, dandy, sir. Just dandy. Oh, great heavens above!
Is that you, John?
Hello, Dutch.
I think that's what they call two for the price of one out here in this wonderful place.
Maybe so, Dutch.
You and your friend there, the professor, we're gonna kill the both of you.
Why you wanna do a thing like that?
I don't know. Sport, I guess.
Fair enough. Why don't I come out there? We fight. Let the professor go and send your boys back to their families.
Well, that sounds like a beautiful plan, John. Only problem is, my boys here, they already lost their families a long time ago. We aren't thieves, John. We're fighting for something a bit like you. Only we're fighting for an idea, not just for ourselves.
That's beautiful, Dutch. You always were a fine speaker.
I was. Now, would you kindly send that academic out here so we can show him what we really think about the art of anthropology?
Please, sir, what are we going to do?
I'm gonna hand you over to him and watch him tear you limb from limb.
What?
I'm just kidding. We're gonna run across the rooftops. Get you back to your ivory tower.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Don't thank me. We're still here. Come on.
Oh!
Yes. Oh, come here.
Good day, sir. Madam.
Look here, sir. What is the meaning of this outrage?
You two stay down and shut up.
Come on. We can get to the roof this way. Ah, my research is complete. Much as I thought, there's no civilizing this savage land.
I could have told you that for nothing.
What do you want, Marston?
My family. I've done what you asked.
No, you haven't. This is the land of opportunity, and I gave you the opportunity to save your family, and you failed. How could I possibly reward you?
Marston, you're a public menace. We should have had you killed.
I wish you had. But since you didn't, where's my family?
Oh, spare me the noble savage falling the sword tripe, will you, old boy? It's nauseating. You don't wish to be dead. You're an insignificant creature, desperately clinging on to life like the rest of the scum in this town. Yeah, I know, it's tough. You like Dutch. He's a charming fellow. He makes sense. He's like one of those nature writers from back east, only he takes things a tiny little step too far. Rather than just loving the flowers and the animals and the harmony between man and beast, he shoots people in the head for money and disagreeing with them.
He's a goddamn killer.
Now, I'm not a great intellect, but the metaphysical leap from admiring the flower to shooting a man in the head because he doesn't like the flower is a leap too far. So, I know it's easy. You see, me and Archer, we're the bad guys. We enforce the rules. Now, while the rules may not be perfect, they're really not so bad.
Exactly. What's the alternative?
Yeah. See, I'll tell you what the alternative is. It's not complicated. It's about one man and his gun versus another man. Sure, civilization may be dull, but the alternative, Mr. Marston, is hell.
And the way you enforce this civilization, this freedom for men to like or not like flowers or whatever in God's name you were just talking about, is to kidnap a man's wife and son?
Well, I know there's contradictions. I'm not going to lie to you. Yeah, as I said, I'm not a great intellect. Now, after the debacle with the army and the bank, we have to put Mr. Vanderlyn to rest ourselves. Will you help us?
Do I have any choice?
Now that you mention it, no.
Then what was that pretty speech in aid of?
I don't rightly know, but it sure felt good saying it.
Shall we, Mr. Marston?
Let's go.
You, blow that gate open. Move, soldier.
Forward!
Right, Marston. We'll take two men with us. The rest will stay here and take care of the wounded. They'll plant charges at the gate. You and I will provide the cover fire.
You tend to your wounded. I gotta face Dutch alone.
Looks like it's me and you, John. You should have stayed at home. Son of a bitch! God damn it! You'll never take me alive, John! It's over, John.
I ain't leaving here without you!
You can't erase the past, John! Killing me, it won't make it go away!
Hello again, John.
Hello, Dutch.
We gotta stop meeting like this.
Sure.
I got a plan, John.
You always got a plan, Dutch.
This is a good one.
I don't doubt it.
We can't always fight nature, John. We can't fight change. Can't fight gravity. We can't fight nothing. My whole life, all I ever did was fight.
Then give up, Dutch.
But I can't give up, neither. I can't fight my own nature. That's a paradox, John. You see?
Then I have to shoot you.
When I'm gone, they'll just find another monster. They have to. Because they have to justify their wages.
That's their business.
Our time has passed, John.
So at the end, you didn't have the guts to shoot him.
The man's dead, Ross.
Sure. Can I see your gun? Oh, trust me. It looks better in the report that way.
Where's my family?
Your wife was killed in a prison riot last week. So, I'm only joking, dear boy. They were sent back to that Scrabble ranch of yours in Beecher's Hope. They're quite safe and sound.
They better be.
Thank you, Mr. Marston, for everything. I know this wasn't easy for you, but I have to say, you've done your country proud.
Yeah, exactly. See you around, John. Try to stay out of trouble. Come on, Archer. Let's go find somebody else we can annoy.
Now I know the only compass that I need.
Abigail!
Is the one.
Jack! Anyone here?
He's back to you. And I know the only compass that I need.
Oh, darling. I never thought I'd see this day again.
You no good hillbilly piece of shit! I thought you was dead! I thought you was dead, John, huh? Where you been? Where you been?
You know where I've been, darling. You know!
You saw Dutch, didn't you?
Yeah, I saw him.
And Bill?
Yeah, I saw him, too.
And you didn't go back to him?
I left that life, just as you left yours. How'd they treat you?
Oh, I can take care of myself, John. One guard got funny on me one time, but I wasn't so ladylike, and he didn't try it again.
nor no one else.
How's the boy?
Well, like you, and like me, well, he's like a kid growing up without a father.
That ain't fair.
What is fair?
Well, some trees flourish, others die. Some cattle grow strong, others are taken by wolves. Some men are born rich enough and dumb enough to enjoy their lives. Ain't nothing fair, you know that.
We tried to change, I mean, ain't that what you're supposed to do?
We did change. It's over now. Jack! Jack, come here, boy.
Hello, sir.
Come here. How you been?
Coyotes ate all the chickens and poachers took the cattle. I tried, Father. I tried.
I know you did, son. I know.
And don't you go blaming me, boy.
Don't you go blaming me.
I ain't blaming no one, old man, but since you're still alive, there's four mouths to feed. And no cattle.
That's a nice way to greet somebody. Why don't I get the warm and tender embrace?
Consider the fact I ain't put a bullet in your embrace, old man. You were supposed to look after the place.
I did. Well, I did my best. Thing is, there was too many of them. I thought you was dead. I wasn't drinking.
Hold your excuses until you figured out which one to use. Jack, go get your bags packed, boy. We got work to do. We leave in the morning. Go on.
Yes, sir.
Where are you going?
Well, it's getting kind of dark now, but in the morning we've got to go get ourselves some more cattle. I've got friends at McFarland's ranch. It's over in Hennigan's stead who can sell us some. Now, Abigail, I hope you learn to cook.
Yes. Didn't I say? Rather than some prison, they actually kept me incarcerated in a cooking school for young ladies.
What you cooking?
Same thing I've been cooking the past 15 years with the hope of poisoning you.
Ain't working so well.
Not yet.
I'll be honest, though. Tastes bad enough to kill a man.
I never was much of a cook, but I did try to be a good wife.
And you have been.
Given what we was and what we came from, I think we've gone and done okay. I look at Jack. I look at him, and I think we've been blessed. Maybe he can be something more.
He's a good kid. He can be whatever he wants to be. He ain't gonna be no frontier gunslinger killing and running no gang, though. That way's over. Railroads and government and motor cars and everything gone and done away with all that.
And he ain't gonna marry no orphaned working girl running with a bunch of hucksters, neither.
If he meets one like you, I hope he'll marry her.
Stop. For an illiterate gunslinger, you sure know how to make a girl blush.
What's the book, boy?
Nothing, sir.
What's it about?
Well, it's an adventure, sir. Set out in the West, and it tells this amazing story of how people killed the savage Redskins, and how this man, this brave man, hunts the man who killed his father.
I'm glad you're enjoying it. Talking of adventure, how'd you like to learn to track elk? Really big ones in the valley this time of year. We could use the meat.
Well, I
know you'd rather read your adventures. Trust me, this can be very enjoyable in its own way.
I suppose maybe it's a little less dramatic. So, let's go, come on. You may get to see me get gored by some massive wild beast. Then you can write a story about that.
Very funny, Paul. I've forgotten how funny you was.
Grab your things. Tensing up.
I'm not.
You are. Your back's tense and it's making the rifle jump. You're holding it wrong. Here, let me show you.
I don't need you to show me, Paul.
I guess not.
Well, show me and you'll just run off again or something. It's better I teach myself.
I ain't going nowhere.
Whatever you say, Paul.
Don't be like that.
Sorry.
Wolves been after the herd. Gotta get out there and scare them off. You wanna come with me? Safer with two.
Okay.
Take a look at that.
Jack, go into the house, lock all the doors. Whatever happens, don't come outside. You hear me? Whatever happens.
Okay.
Come here, son. Whatever happens, keep the doors locked and your mother inside. Promise me, son. Promise me.
Who is it, Pa?
It's just some old friends. Me and Uncle take care of it. And you go inside and you keep the doors and the windows locked.
I hear you.
Then run!
Yeah, run, boy.
Well, old man, looks like things is about to get settled once and for all.
So it seems.
What are we gonna do now?
What's wrong? What's happened?
Stay inside, you hear? Like I said, there'll be more coming.
All right, you catch him again! Uncle, are you all right?
Damn it! I've been hit!
Hang in there, Uncle! I'm gonna get you out of here safe!
Ain't time, John. I ain't gonna make it off this porch anyhow. You take Jack and Abby. Take them and... Don't worry about me. Just get them out of here.
No! Uncle, please! Oh, my God! They killed him!
Come on, son! Ain't nothing we can do for him now! We're leaving the farm. I'll watch from the silo. You two go to the barn. Get the horses ready.
John!
I'll meet you there. Hey, come on. Now listen, Jack, darling, get on this horse. Get out of here. Go find a place to hide.
You're coming with us, Paul.
I'll catch up. You keep riding and don't look back. And don't be worrying about me, you hear? Now get going.
You stay out of trouble, John.
Ain't no trouble, Abigail. Ain't no trouble. I love you.
I love you.
Now go. Get!
Excuse me. You Edgar Ross?
Do I know you?
Forgive me for startling you, sir, but I have a message for you. My name is Jack Marston. You knew my father.
I see. I remember your father.
I've come for you, Ross.
And you, boy, have sure shit found me.
You killed my father.
Your father killed himself with the life he lived.
You killed him. I saw you.
You keep saying that.
You sent him to do your dirty work. Then you shot him like a dog.
And I'll shoot you like one too, you little piece of trash. Now get out of here before I kill you as well.
I ain't going nowhere, old man.
And all the storms
clouds you've been chasing, about to rain down tonight. And all the pain you've been facing, about to come into the light.